This is your sports TV station in Lorain, WLCS TV 20.
And may we say, better late than never from the Pipe Yard on Meister Road in Lorain, Ohio. Good Sunday evening, everyone, and welcome to the WEOL Colson and Colson Diamond Duel. We have been waiting and waiting here in Lorain, but high school baseball will be played on this Sunday night as the Lorain High Titans at 10-4 on the year take on the Elyria High Pioneers, who have made the trip to Lorain with a record of 5-7. Tim Elkhorn, along with on-site engineer and color commentary provided by Jared Kozar tonight, back in the studios of AM 930 WEOL. Spinning the dials, our very own Alan Calcaterra. And indeed, we have waited a while to get this one underway. Just to recap it for you, originally there was a doubleheader scheduled for today here at the Pipe Yard in Lorain. Game one was scheduled to be Vermilion and Clearview. They were supposed to play that game at 2 o'clock this afternoon, followed by Elyria and Lorain at 6 o'clock. Well, Vermilion and Clearview got wiped out due to the wet grounds here at the Pipe Yard in Lorain. But since about 4 o'clock this afternoon, a little after 4 o'clock, they have been working and working and working to try to get this field into playable condition. Certainly, it's not ideal. There are some wet spots in the infield, and certainly the outfield is pretty drenched. But the two managers, or two head coaches, as they call them in high school baseball, Brad Turnus of Lorain and Ed Piazza of Elyria High, along with the umpires, have deemed it playable. And so we will get this game underway in just a couple of moments, about 90 minutes later than anticipated, but it will be Elyria and Lorain. And Jared, we were talking right before we came out on the air. Hey, hats off to the guys who have tried to get this field into playing shape tonight. The grounds crew and the guys working here in Lorain have done a phenomenal job.
Absolutely, Tim. Yeoman's work out of this crew out here. Again, at the high school level, you have to wonder if you've ever seen that kind of effort for guys to work for about 2 hours solid prior to the start of a ball game to make sure that they get that drying agent down in the infield, because it's not going to be pretty if they don't get the proper amount out there. And it looks like they've done an adequate job now for sure.
And now from the Pipe Yard in Lorain, the playing of our national anthem. And the playing of the national anthem here at the Pipe Yard in Lorain. And we're just about set to get this ball game underway. Again, Elyria at 5-7, Lorain at 10-4. The pitching matchup, it'll be left-hander Adrian Calez on the hill for the Lorain High Titans. And he'll be opposed by Elyria High's Steve Poskosil. Let's take a look at the batting order that Elyria High head coach Ed Piazza has put together. Leading off for the Pioneers, it'll be second baseman Mike Izzarelli batting second. Will be the shortstop Chris Emerson hitting third, catcher Mike Perrin. The designated hitter Brody Stewart will be the cleanup hitter tonight for Elyria High. Batting fifth will be the third baseman Jacob Gismadia. Hitting sixth will be the first baseman, K.J. Allgood. Batting seventh will be center fielder, Brendan Kazura. Hitting eighth will be Brad Conley. He'll be out in left field tonight for Elyria High. And hitting ninth will be Tony Pierce, and Pierce will be in right field for Elyria. Defensively for Lorain High, left to right in the outfield, Nick Billingsley will be out in left field. Dede Heisel will be in center, Kyle Stumphauser in right. The infield, Aaron Andahar will be at third, Andre Morales at short, Ryan Osco at second, Tom Holloway at first, Nate Drabiak behind the plate, And again, left-hander Adrian Calez is on the hill tonight for Lorain High. And we welcome all of you who have dialed in not only on WEOL, but on the web at WEOL.com. That live stream brought to you by Luxury Heating and Air Conditioning. Total indoor air quality since 1947. Thanks, Luxury, for giving us the luxury of hearing our games live online at WEOL.com. Sanford, Washington, our home plate umpire says play ball, and Adrian Calez's first pitch to Mike Izzarelli is a called strike, and we're about 90 minutes later than anticipated, but we are underway here at the Pipe Yard in Lorain. Calez's 0-1 pitch, low and away, evens up the count at 1-1. I mentioned Sanford, Washington behind the plate, and our infield umpire tonight is Nandi Cruz. Adrian Calez looking into Nate Drabiak. The 1-1 pitch skied off to the right and out of play. The count 1-2 on Pioneer leadoff hitter Mike Izzarelli. You folks listening in Lorain tonight, you'll be able to watch this game in the near future on WLCS TV 20, Lorain City Schools Television. Joe Bach has tied into our audio feed tonight. Good to see Joe again. Next pitch hit down the right field line, giving chase his Stumphauser, and that ball will splash foul in the bullpen down the right field line. Haven't seen Joe Bach in a while. It was good to see him. And then I saw that Pittsburgh hat on his head, and it spoiled everything.
He probably shook it down for a lunch or two that you might have owed him at some point. So that's another thing that you got to think about. Every time you run into Joe Bach, you run the risk of possibly coming up with a meal.
You know, Joe Bach owed me a lunch for 2 months. He finally took me out to lunch on a gift card he got for Christmas. He didn't even pick up the tab. Somebody else picked up the tab as Joe Bach splurged with that gift card. Oh, he's a big spender, that Joe Bach. Here's the 1-2 pitch to Izzarelli. That one's fouled behind home plate. Mike Izzarelli, right-handed batter against the left-hander, Adrian Calez. Again, this game was held up for about an hour and a half, but we are underway here at the Pipe Yard in Lorain. There's a swing and a miss by Calez. Ball dropped by Drabiak. He will throw it down to first for the first out here in the top of the first inning. So Mike Izzarelli is a strikeout victim. One up, one down for Elyria High. That'll bring on Chris Emerson, right-handed hitting shortstop. Facing southpaw, Adrian Calez. Calez on the year is 2-0. Oh and one the count on Chris Emerson. Calez's next delivery, that one bounces away from catcher Nate Drabiak. I'll tell you what, for the elements being not nearly ideal for high school baseball on a Sunday night, quite a few folks have made their way over to the Pipe Yard, and they waited very patiently for this game to get underway. There's a strike on the inside corner, and the count is now 1-2 on Chris Emerson. And those fans, like us, just waited and waited as they worked the field. There's a slow topper grabbed by Calez, throws over to first, low throw, and it wasn't able to be dug out by Thomas Holloway. And on is Chris Emerson.
Pretty good job by Calez there to get to the ball. Made an adequate throw, to just couldn't dig it out over there at first base. But a good play to get off the mound, make the throw, gather himself. Those field conditions are going to be pretty sloppy. You don't know what you'll be grabbing at the rest of the evening.
E3, gentlemen. Yeah. You always have to ask the print guys, just so we're all on the same page. So we're saying that Holloway could have dug that one out. So air on the first baseman, Thomas Holloway. And Emerson is on as Mike Perrin steps in. He bounces one to third. Bobbled throw down to second, and it skips by second baseman Ryan Osco and goes into right field. And that will allow Emerson to go all the way over to third on the play. So Perrin is on with the fielder's choice, and on the throwing error by third baseman Aaron Andahar, heading up over at third base is Chris Emerson, and so the Pioneers with an early threat. Boy, the Lorain High defense letting them down here in the top of the first. Two errors on the first three batters. And now Pioneer cleanup hitter Brody Stewart will step in. Another right-handed batter in that Elyria lineup. Emerson at third, Perrin at first, one down. Lorain defense playing at double play depth, hoping they could turn two right here. Galez from the stretch, the pitch down low for ball one. And actually, Jared, it now looks as though the skies are starting to lighten up a little bit. Although we were checking the radar before we came out on the air, it looks like there is some more rain coming. So we'll get as much baseball in as we can. There's a called strike. The runner goes, and the throw goes into center field. Coming in to score easily is Emerson. And now Perrin rounding third. He will try to score. The throw, the tag, out at the plate is Mike Perrin. Well, Perrin was off with the pitch, and the throw by Nate Drabiak went all the way into center field. That allowed Emerson to basically walk on in from third, and then Perrin got up and tried to come all the way around to score, and he was gunned down at the plate. Although Ed Piazza wants Sanford Washington to have a conversation with Nandy Cruz just to make sure that tag was applied on Mike Perrin.
From up here, Tim, they made the tag. It was a dynamite throw from Didi Heiselot in center field, and Drabiak really didn't have to go very far to get it. He was able to regather himself and make a play. I think for sure that was a great throw and catch there for Lorain.
And the call will stand. So Elyria does get a run, as, again, Emerson could basically stroll home when that throw went into center field, and then Ed Piazza decided to gamble with Perrin and send him all the way around. And, Jared, as you said, that was a terrific throw by D.D. Heisel. So there are now two down, nobody on, and there's a called strike to Brody Stewart. So even though Lorain gives up a run here, actually they're pretty fortunate because now the bases are empty with two outs as Brody Stewart takes a pitch down low. And the count is now 1-2 on the Pioneer cleanup hitter. That had the makings of a big inning. Two balls, two strikes, two out. A runner or a run in for Elyria High here in the top of the first inning. So after the Lorain High defense had really played some sloppy baseball here in the top of the first, a tremendous defensive play by Heisel bails them out. And now I think they want to make sure everybody's on the same page with the count. Scoreboard has 2-2. As Sanford and Dondi Cruz are again going to have a conversation. Did they determine that it was still 2-2, Jared? Were you able to pick up on that?
Should still be 2-2. Scoreboard still reads 2-2. I think there was a little bit of confusion on whether there was a called strike on the throw to the outfield.
2-2 pitch inside as it spins Brody Stewart out of the way. And the count now runs full on the Pioneer cleanup hitter. Come on, Brody. Elyria with a run in here in the top of the first. The 3-2 pitch from Kalez fouled to the screen right behind home plate. Count remains full. Vermilion and Clearview were supposed to play earlier today here at the Pipe Yard. That game was canceled. Elyria and Lorain scheduled to start at 6. Got underway at about 7:35. Well, we're playing baseball. There's another pitch fouled to the screen. And the count remains full on Brody Stewart. Adrian Kalez with that 2-0 mark. Left-hander delivers. That one skied a mile high in the infield. Second baseman Ryan Osco settles under it. And that'll do it for the Pioneers here in the top of the first. So Stewart pops out to retire the side. Elyria scores a run. There were no hits, three errors on Lorain here in the top of the first. Pioneers with a 1-0 lead as we head to the bottom of the first on the Colson and Colson Diamond Duel. It's on AM 930 WEOL. And Jared, we're streaming live on the web
at WEOL.com.
Makes a difference. Learn more at CasaFamilyDay.org.
Coming your way on this Sunday night from the Pipe Yard here in Lorain, Tim Elkhorn, Jared Kozar, back in the studios of AM 930 WEOL, the very best in the business. Alan Calcaterra spinning the dials. And Lorain High will get their first look at Elyria High right-hander Steve Poskasil, who gets the start tonight for Elyria High. Here's the batting order that Brad Turnus, the head coach of Lorain High, has put together to face Poskasil. Leading off, it'll be second baseman Ryan Osco. Hitting second will be the third baseman, Aaron Andahar. Hitting third in the Titan lineup will be shortstop Andre Morales. Hitting fourth, first baseman Thomas Holloway. Batting fifth, Nate Drabiak, the catcher. Hitting sixth, Nick Billingsley out in left field tonight for Lorain High. The designated hitter, Mike Velez, will be hitting seventh. In the eighth spot, Kyle Stumphauser in right. And hitting ninth, D.D. Heisel, the center fielder. Ryan Osco to lead off for Lorain High. Steve Poskasil on the hill for Elyria High. Poskasil with a record of 1-0 coming into tonight's ballgame. And his first pitch of the night bounces into battery mate Mike Perrin for ball one. For Elyria High defensively, out in the outfield, left to right, Brad Conley in left. Brandon Kazura in center, Tony Pierce in right. Next pitch from Poskasil is a called strike on the outside corner, evens up the count at 1-1. The infield, Jacob Chismadia is at third, Chris Emerson at short, Mike Izzarelli at second, KJ Allgood at first, Mike Perrin behind the plate. Here's the 1-1 pitch, down low, count now 2-1 on Ryan Osco. Elyria with a 1-0 lead. We are in the bottom of the first here at the Pipe Yard in Lorain. Poskasil rocks, throws. That pitch drops down low. And the count is now 3-1 on Ryan Osco. Lorain High in their home whites tonight. White shirts, gray pants, blue letters and numbers with some blue trim. Next pitch, bouncing ball to short. Scooped up by Emerson, throws across in time. One up, one down for Lorain High here in the bottom of the first. Elyria High in their red shirts, bright red tops, white letters and numbers trimmed into black with the brand new white pants. That's what Ed Piazza was telling us before the ball game.
Certainly a great night for white pants, Tim.
Now, is there ever a bad night for white pants, Jared? Where are you going with that? Here's Aaron Andujar, who takes a called strike.
Well, just with the field conditions being what they were, even presently with all the work that's been done, you wonder if the black alternates weren't a better idea for this evening.
Here's the 0-1 pitch to Andujar. That's a called strike, and quickly, Steve Poskasil is ahead of Aaron Andujar at 0-2. Now, I know back in your younger days when you were getting ready for a night on the town, the white pants were always first out of the closet, weren't they, Jerry?
You wanted to go with that Miami Vice Sonny Crockett look was big, and it never really let people down either. So for Elyria right now, it's interesting, Tim, and they were able to get that first out there without much of a hassle. But you've got to wonder, a 90-minute delay to begin the game, and they were on the field taking practice for most of that time.
Next pitch from Poskasil floats outside as he tried to get Aaron Andujar to chase one. The count is now 1-2. On the Lorain High third baseman. Titans at 10-4. They're putting together a nice season. They've won 6 of their last 7 games. Elyria at 5-7. Next pitch fouled away by Andujar. Count remains 1-2. No, you're right. That's a long time to stand around and try to stay warm, stay loose. Both teams were trying to get some running in and some stretching in, playing a little long toss.
You can only do that for so long in a game like that. And then, like you said, when are we going to get this one going? Are we going to get this one going? It's tough to stay loose sometimes.
One down for Lorain High here in the bottom of the first. They trail it 1-0. Poskasil's next pitch, strike three, call. Boy, he cut the inside corner right there. Aaron Andahar is a strikeout victim. Two down for the Titans here in the home half of the first. That'll bring on Andre Morales. We had a beautiful day yesterday in LaGrange for the Priebus tournament. And actually, after tonight, the weather's supposed to break, and we're supposed to have a real nice week ahead of us as the first pitch to Morales is a called strike. That rain just moved in today and decided to wreak havoc with baseball here at the Pipe Yard. But Elyria and Lorain, we're in the bottom of the first. Pitch fouled off to the right, and quickly Poskasil is ahead of Andre Morales at 0-2.
We mentioned the weather being a factor. You don't want to spoil it for the fans and the listeners right now, but the crew did a great job, and this is probably the only window they have to get this game in as we're facing something else later this evening.
Another pitch fouled off to the right. Count remains 0-2, or 1-2, excuse me, on Andre Morales. Two down, nobody on for Lorain High. Bottom of the first here at the Pipe Yard. Steve Poskasil, right-hander on the hill for Elyria High, rocks, throws a swing and a miss for strike three. Lorain goes in order. Three up, three down. One in the books here at the Pipe Yard. 1-0 Elyria as we head to the top of inning number two on the Colson and Colson Diamond Duel. We're on WEOL and we're on the web
at WEOL.com.
I knew I needed help paying for college. I've always wanted to be a teacher. I used to make worksheets for my friends to do. No one ever wanted to come over. My guidance counselor told me about federal student aid, and my mom helped me fill out the free application. I got the grants and loans that made school possible. There is a way to pay for school. You just have to find it. My name is Caitlin. I'm going to be a special education teacher. I'm going to live my dream.
Tim Elkhorn, Jared Kozar here at the Pipe Yard in Lorain. We welcome you back. One inning in the book. Elyria High leading Lorain by a score of 1-0. Great big thank you to our sponsors for tonight's ball game, and of course, Joe Bach, B-O-C-K, WLCS-TV-20, Lorain City Schools Television has tied into our audio. So for those of you that are listening in Lorain tonight, WLCS-TV-20, Lorain City Schools Television. You'll be able to watch this one in the very near future. Adrian Calez on the hill for Lorain High. His first pitch in the top of the second to Jacob Chismadia is up high for ball one. It'll be Chismadia, KJ Allgood, and Brendan Kazura for Elyria High here in the top of the second. Next pitch low and away, and Calez has fallen behind Chismadia at 2-0. Elez's next offering just on the outside corner. The count now 2-1. We were talking in between innings that I'm sure Sanford Washington has expanded that strike zone just a little bit. There's a line shot into left field. It'll be over the head of Billingsley. It is gone! Chismadia clears the fence by about a foot. A solo home run for Jacob Chismadia, and the Pioneers lead it by a score of 2-0. Jared, I didn't think that ball was out of here.
No, it seemed like he gave chase out there and lefty. You thought to yourself, it burned him, but you didn't think it was going to go over. And then, obviously, it carried more than we thought out there, and you don't know if the wind's a factor at this stage in the evening yet, but clearly, ball got out faster than we thought.
It sure did. So Chismadia with a solo home run to give Elyria High a 2-0 lead here in the top of the second inning, and that'll bring on KJ Allgood. Right-handed hitting first baseman for Elyria High against Adrian Calez, and Calez's first pitch is up and in for ball one. And now Nate Drabiak, catcher for Lorain High, is going to take a trot out to the hill and have a conversation with Adrian Calez. Our next Colson and Colson Diamond Duel Thursday. We'll make our way over to Keystone. It'll be the Keystone Wildcats taking on the Firelands Falcons in high school baseball action. Patriot Athletic Conference ball game. Next pitch to Allgood. A swing and a miss. I think Adrian Calez took a little bit off that pitch. And the count evens up on Allgood at 1-1. Adrian Calez working from that full windup. He delivers. There's another swing and a miss as Allgood chased one up high. And the count is now 1-2 on KJ.
You mentioned the off-speed stuff, Tim. Drabiak might have went out there and said, listen, if you don't want to go back-to-back, might want to take something off of these next two pitches here.
There's a curveball that stays up. And the count is now 2-2 on KJ Allgood. Elyria with a run in the first and a run in the second. Pioneers lead this one 2-0 here at the Pipe Yard in Lorain. Galez's next pitch skied a mile high down the left field line. Billingsley in foul territory will watch it drift out of play. And Allgood will come all the way back to the plate and try it again. Of course, these two teams have squared off here at the Pipe Yard in Lorain on Sunday nights for the past few seasons as part of Rube Foster Night. Now, the Rube Foster festivities have been done away with, but it's good to see Lorain and Elyria going at it. One of the great rivalries as far as this area is concerned, no matter what the sport. Galez rocks and throws, and Allgood got hit by the pitch. He couldn't twist out of the way of that one. And so K.J. Allgood will trot down to first base.
Number six, you mentioned they've gone at it for a couple of seasons now, Tim, and it's very good. On a Sunday night, you sort of showcase yourself. You know, you traditionally you have the Tribe play in the afternoon, so we're able to bring it to everybody, and we enjoy doing that. And that's another thing with the weather being what it was today, glad you can get this one in because you don't know what kind of opportunities you get to play at a Sunday evening ball game.
And you mentioned the Tribe, by the way. We will join the Indians in progress tonight. We'll have that game in progress as they had that day-night doubleheader in Kansas City. First game didn't go too well. Tribe loses out in KC as Brendan Kazura bunts and fouls one back to the screen for strike one. Brendan Kazura, the number 7 hitter in the Pioneer lineup, steps in with nobody out and Allgood down at first. Elyria already with a 2-0 lead. Calez working from the stretch. The pitch, that ball smoked to second and it goes over the glove of Osco in the center field for a base hit. Allgood will go all the way over to third. The throw, the tag, safe at third. The throw was a little bit offline, and Allgood was able to beat the tag by Aaron Andahar. And down to second on the throw went Kazura. So Elyria High now with an opportunity right here for a big inning. But that ball took a wicked hop on second baseman Ryan Osco. It looked like he had it played very well, and then it just skipped right over his glove.
Oh, he was in position, Tim, and another good job out there by Didi Heisel to back him up and made a good throw, just didn't get the tag down in time.
So Allgood at third, Kazura now down at second. Well, they just called
they
Kazura.
Called him out.
They called Allgood out for not touching second base. So another break for Lorain High. Boy, Lorain High got a great throw from Heisel in the first. That nailed a runner at the plate. And now they're going to get Allgood called out for not stepping on second base. So one out. Kazura still down at second as Brad Conley steps in and takes a pitch up high for ball one. Galez working from the stretch. The 1-0 pitch inside. And the count is now 2-0 on the number 8 hitter in the Elyria lineup, Brad Conley. Well, Galez has gotten a little help here in the first couple of innings. Let's see if he can work his way out of this jam. Next pitch skips in low to Brad Conley. Right-handed hitting left fielder for Elyria High. And white number 8 trimmed in black on the back of his red shirt. As a look down at head coach Ed Piazza in that third base coaching box. Count 3-0. I would think Eddie's going to have him taking all the way right here. The 3-0 offering is a called strike on the inside corner. We talked about the wide strike zone. Count now 3-1 on Conley. 2-0, Pioneers. They're looking to add to their advantage. Next pitch, low and inside for ball four. So that'll put runners at first and second with one out. Tony Pierce, the number 9 hitter in the Elyria lineup, will now step in. Runners at first and second and one out. Elyria already with a run in the inning on Jacob Chismadia's solo home run. There's a pitch on the inside corner for strike one. Boy, Adrian Calez for Lorain High really working the inside portion of the plate. Doesn't want to see those Elyria batters extend those arms. He's jamming the right-handed hitters.
Sometimes that'll happen, I think, early in a ball game, Tim, after a pitcher gives up a dinger like that. You think to yourself, what can I do to get back to basics here and keep these guys off the plate, and keep them from extending? Maybe that's what he's going to there.
Calez from the stretch, the pitch. That one's golfed out into left. Billingsley giving chase. It's over his head. It'll go all the way to the warning track. Kazura will come around third to score. Here comes Conley, and the throw in, offline. Conley will score. Pierce ends up in third, and the Pioneers now with a 4-0 lead. A two-run triple from Tony Pierce, and Elyria High with a 3-run uprising here in the top of the second inning. And back to the top of the order we go as Mike Izzarelli will now step in for Elyria High. And now another appeal play as they throw over to appeal Tony Pierce, but he's fine right where he is at third base. So Elyria now with a 4-0 lead. Still only one out, and there's a ball smoked down the left field line. That'll be a fair ball. Pierce will walk home to make it 5-0. Izzarelli will head to second base with a stand-up double. Mike Izzarelli with an RBI two-bagger to make it a 5-0 Pioneer advantage.
Boys, in for Brad Turnus' ball club. I think after the first inning, you get out of there only giving up one run, but allowing three errors, and then you think to yourself, what can we do to not compile on this? And you got to stay away from the big inning, and they're just not able to do it right now.
Izzarelli down at second. Chris Emerson will now step in for Elyria High. The Pioneers with four runs here in the second inning. Could have been more. K.J. Allgood was retired only because he didn't touch second base. Calez's pitch down low to Emerson for ball one. 5-0 Elyria. One out here in the top of the second. Indians baseball to follow right here on WEOL. We will have the Tribe in progress as they play game two of their day-night doubleheader in Kansas City. Tribe wrapping up that road swing. The pitch from Calez, that one just a bit low. The count is 2-0 on Chris Emerson.
Pretty shocked to hear this, the first ever day-night doubleheader at Kauffman Stadium in 40 seasons. The first ever is today.
I did not hear that. Next pitch fouled off to the right. The count is 2-1 on Chris Emerson. I didn't have a chance to listen to Hammy and Rosie for game one. Had a round trip down to Columbus earlier today. Well, that's a nice two-hour drive back and forth in a pouring rain. Calez working from the stretch, and now he steps off the rubber, makes a motion towards second base. Didn't throw there, but Izzarelli dove back. Dirtied up those beautiful, clean white pants, Jared. And this time they do throw. The ball ricochets off Izzarelli in the hole between short and third. Now they throw over to third. Ball gets by Andahar. And here comes Izzarelli down the line. Dives and scores. And Elyria now with a 6-0 lead. Boy, the roof has caved in for Lorain High defensively here in the first couple of innings. And Brad Turnus is going to head to the hill and have a talk with his entire infield.
Action going on in the Lorain bullpen. Can't see who's up throwing there, Tim, but you got to think maybe he's trying to buy his guy a little bit of time here and see what move can be made.
So Izzarelli comes all the way around to score. Again, Kalez turned and fired to second base, and the ball actually glanced off Izzarelli, and it ricocheted between short and third. Morales picked it up, tried to throw to third, and the ball skipped by Andujar, and that gave Izzarelli the time to come around and score. And Elyria High now with a 6-0 advantage. Five runs here in the second. Well, Brad Ternus has had his conversation with the entire Titan infield. And now for Lorain High, it's basically let's start all over. One down, nobody on, but Elyria High with a 5-run outburst here in the second. Pitch to Emerson is a called strike. Evens up the count at 2-2. Emerson reached on an error his first time up and came around to score. There's a swing and a miss. Drabiak dropped the ball, throws down the first in time to retire Emerson on the strikeout. For Kalez, that's his second strikeout in the ballgame. Going to bring on Mike Perrin. Perrin reached on a fielder's choice his first time up. Little delay in the action as baseball down in that left field bullpen where Lorain High is warming somebody up got loose. Eddie Piazza had to track it down, and now the first pitch to Perrin is a called strike. 6-0 Elyria High. Pioneers with a run in the first and five here in the second. Next pitch to Perrin, that's a called strike on the outside corner. And quickly, Adrian Kalez is ahead of Mike Perrin at 0-2. Perrin, the eighth Pioneer to bat in the inning. Next pitch, curveball that stays up high. And the count is now 2-1. Perrin now steps out of that batter's box. Of course, the lights are on here at the Pipe Yard. That's another reason we could wait this one out a little bit. Next pitch, low and inside to Perrin. We were talking during that 90-minute delay. A couple of reasons they really wanted to get this one in. Number one, it's Elyria Lorain. And as Jared mentioned, you're not quite sure when you would be able to make this game up. Number two, the fact that it had stopped raining as the next pitch is fouled out of play. At least gave the grounds crew an opportunity, that window, as Jared said, to work on the field. And then obviously the fact that you have lights here at the Pipe Yard. So you could afford to go until 7:30 and see if you could get this one started. Of course, the Pipe Yard, one of the few fields in our area that has lights. The pitch from Kalez way outside for ball four. So Mike Perrin draws a walk.
I think there's something to be said for, and of course it's easy for us to say because we're up here, but not a bad night for baseball right now either from
not
a spectator
now.
Standpoint. Now you're out there, those guys are getting a little bit of a different feel for it, but no, not a bad evening at all.
Here's Brody Stewart as Elyria High sends their ninth batter to the plate this inning. First pitch to Stewart. Inside there goes the runner, throw down on a big bounce, deflects into center field, but backed up nicely by Ryan Osco. But Mike Perrin has himself a stolen base. Now, the fans appear fairly comfortable. There's some with some blankets, but for the most part, folks either have on the hoodies or some jackets. It's not that brutal cold that we've had in some games this year. I know that Saturday morning that you and I were over at Elyria Catholic, Jared, for Elyria High and the Panthers, that was cold. Next pitch to Brody Stewart is a called strike. And I know last Saturday, the game that Rob had over at Elyria, Avon Lake and the Pioneers, Rob said that was about as cold a game as he has ever called. That was just horrendous. Next pitch, golfed into center field. D.D. Heisel coming on, and he makes the shoulder-high catch to retire Brody Stewart and retire the side. But Elyria High bats around, and the Pioneers in the inning with 5 runs. And at the end of an inning and a half, Elyria High with a 6-0 advantage over Lorain. We're coming back to the Pipe Yard here on Meister Road in Lorain. Following this on the Colson and Colson Diamond Duel on WEOL and Jared on the web.
At WEOL.com.
Hi, I'm Rochelle Lefebvre and this is Johnny. We're working with Best Friends Animal Society to stop the suffering of millions of breeding dogs in puppy mills who supply puppies to pet stores. You can help too by not adding to the demand for pet store puppies. When searching for your next best friend, do what I did. Adopt. Don't shop. Let a shelter dog like Johnny steal your heart.
6-0, Elyria leading Lorain as we head to the bottom of the second here at the Pipe Yard in Lorain. Tim Elkhorn, Jared Kozar on site. Back in the studios of WEOL, our very own Alan Calcaterra. And, of course, tonight's game heard online at WEOL.com. That live stream brought to you by Luxury Heating and Air Conditioning. Total indoor air quality since 1947. Thanks, Luxury, for giving us the luxury of hearing every single one of our games online at WEOL.com. Lorain High will have to chip away as they trail this one 6-0 for the Titans here in the bottom of the second. It'll be Thomas Holloway, Nate Drabiak, and Nick Billingsley against Pioneer right-hander Steve Poskosil. And Holloway foul tips the first pitch for strike one. Poskosil set Lorain down in order in the home half of the first. Boy, that seems like a long time ago after Elyria batted around in the top of the second when they scored 5. Next pitch to Holloway, low and away, evens up the count at 1-1. Poskosil had 2 strikeouts in that first. There's a ball golfed down the left field line. Conley giving chase, and that one is off the wall. Conley able to scoop it up, throws in, and sliding into second base with a double is Thomas Holloway. And right there we saw the field conditions as Holloway with an awkward slide into second base, and you wonder if he got caught up in that real wet dirt out there. They've poured a ton of drying agent on the infield, but that was not a pretty slide by Thomas Holloway.
No, and I think he was doing a fair job laboring around first base when he rounded it. Any head first slide anywhere is going to be pretty ill-advised this evening with the field conditions the way they are.
So a leadoff double for Thomas Holloway here in the bottom of the second for Lorain High. That'll bring on Nate Drabiak as Poskosil will work from the stretch. And Drabiak fouls one to the screen for strike one. And as I said, Lorain High will have to chip away here. You're not going to score 6 runs at once. They need base runners bunched up with some base hits. Holloway gets him started with a double here in the home half of the second. Next pitch, a called strike to Drabiak, and quickly Poskosil is ahead of Nate Drabiak at 0-2. Steve Poskosil, 1-0 on the year, right-hander for the Pioneers. The 0-2 pitch, a curveball. That ball is smoked into center field, and a nice running catch made out there by Brendan Kazura. Quickly throws back in, chasing Holloway back to the bag. Nice play out there by Brendan Kazura for the Pioneers. One out for Lorain here in the bottom of the second. That'll bring on Nick Billingsley.
Nice catch on a ball that Kazura had to come in on, Tim. And we mentioned you can tell what the infield conditions are like, but the outfield, we have no idea what it's like out there, and it's got to be a marsh.
Well, there are some dark green spots out there, which usually indicates that's where there's a lot of water. First pitch to Billingsley is low and inside for ball one. Holloway at second with 1 out here in the home half of the second. Lorain High looking to rally as they trail Elyria by a score of 6-0. Poskosil from the stretch. The pitch right down the pipe. Evens up the count at 1-1. Jared, I've mentioned before, I know there's tournament games here in May. The PipeYard really is a terrific facility. Next pitch low and away, count now 2-1 on Nick Billingsley.
They do an excellent job.
They really do. It's comfortable for fans. Of course, the Ironmen play here throughout the summer. Here's the 2-1 pitch inside to Nick Billingsley. The count now 3-1. They often talk in business about location, location, location. I think that's the challenge with the PipeYard. People need to know where it is. Kind of nestled in on Meister Road here in Lorain. And now Poskosil will step off the rubber, chasing Holloway back.
Now, if you're not looking for the sign, you can drive right by it if you're not already aware that it's there. It's one of those things that sneaks up on you when you're going down Meister.
3-1 pitch. Ball four, low and outside. So Nick Billingsley draws a one-out walk to put runners at first and second. And now Michael Velez will step in for Lorain. Velez, the number 7 hitter in the Titan lineup. He's the DH for pitcher Adrian Calez.
No, we're hearing it too.
6-0 Pioneers. We're in the home half of the second here at the PipeYard in Lorain. Titans looking to put together a rally here to get themselves back in this ball game, and the first pitch is a called strike to Michael Velez. 0-1 the count on the Titan DH, right-handed batter against the right-hander Steve Poskosil. Takes a look back at Holloway at second base. 0-1 pitch waved at, and the count 0-2 on Michael Velez. Holloway led off the inning with a double. Drabiak lined out to center field on a well-hit ball that was tracked down by Brandon Kazura. And then Nick Billingsley with a walk. There's a ball fouled off to the right. Count remains 0-2 on Michael Velez. We mentioned that the Ironmen play here in the summer. I know Notre Dame College also plays collegiately here. The 0-2 pitch from Poskosil. And it's a bit outside. The count now 1-2 on Michael Velez. Sanford Washington having a look in that Elyria dugout. Something tells me Eddie Piazza wanted that pitch right there. Poskosil from the stretch. 1-2 pitch. That ball is gulped into left center field. That'll be a base hit. Holloway heading to third, and Brad Ternus will put the brakes on Holloway right there as the bases are now loaded for Lorain High here in the bottom of the second. So Holloway, and again, that infield, he's probably running in some mud out there, so you can't really get the jets going. And so Holloway stays at third. Billingsley is down at second, and on at first with the single is Michael Velez.
You mentioned the field conditions and the base running, Tim. A great move for Coach Ternus to keep his man there on third, not wanting to run himself out of an inning, because you have a chance here to do some damage now with the bases juiced.
As we said, Lorain High needs base runners, trailing by 6. There's a bouncing ball up the middle, scooped up by Emerson. Throw to first, not in time, and a run will score for Lorain High to make it a 6-1 ball game. Everybody safe on the play as they're still loaded up. Stumphauser hit that one up the middle. Emerson bobbled it a little bit and then went for the throw over to first, and Stumphauser able to beat it out. Scoring on the play was Holloway to make it a 6-1 contest. And now D.D. Heisel will step in. So the bases are still loaded for Lorain. A run across, and Heisel will step in and try to make this one a little bit closer. As Jared said, the potential for a big inning right now for the Titans. First pitch to Heisel is up high for ball one. Poskosil now goes back to the full windup with the bases loaded. Next pitch, that's a called strike on the outside corner. Evens up the count at 1-1.
For Elyria right now, Tim, you wonder, we've seen Pascasil behind the dish a few times before. What's the game going on between he and Perrin right now as far as how they're going to get themselves out of this?
Next pitch on the inside corner. We count 1-2 on D.D. Heisel. Of course, we saw Heisel on the hardwood this winter for the Lorain High Titan basketball team. Number 9 hitter in the Titan order. Next pitch just outside. Count evens up at 2-2. Billingsley at third, Velez at second, Stumphauser at first. Lorain has scored a run here in the bottom of the second to make it a 6-1 game. Next pitch is on the, boy, I guess that one was outside. Wow, how did Heisel let that one go by? The count now 3-2. Looked pretty good from here. 3-2 pitch from Pascasil, down low, ball four. He walks in a run as Billingsley will come in to score to make it a 6-2 ball game. So Heisel draws the walk, and again the bases are still loaded. And back to the top of the order we go as Ryan Otsko will step in for the Titans. It's now a 6-2 contest. Boy, now what Pascasil wanted to do right there. Number 9 hitter in the Lorain order. And he's allowing the Titans to put themselves right back in this contest. Otsko steps in. He bounced out to Emerson at short his first time up. Leadoff hitter for Lorain High. Pascasil from the full windup and the pitch right down the middle for strike one. Pascasil looking in to battery mate Mike Perrin. And the 0-1 pitch, that one smoked down the left field line. It'll drop for a base hit. One run scores. Two runs will score. Rounding third is D.D. Heisel. He'll try to score. He does. It's a bases-clearing double for Ryan Otsko. And we've got ourselves a ball game as it is now a 6-5 Pioneer lead. Ryan Otsko knocked that one down the left field line, and it was scooped up by Brad Conley, but it clears the bases, and Lorain High right back in this thing.
You bet they are, Tim. And just a few moments ago, you and I were discussing, well, they're not going to get it all back at once. Well, they're one swing of the bat away from doing just that.
A three-run double by Ryan Otsko. And give Lorain High credit. Boy, they have roared back with five here in the bottom of the second after Elyria scored five in the top of this inning. And how about the speed of Heisel to come all the way around from first and score on that double by Otsko?
And with the field conditions the way they are too, how hard is it to dig out there and get yourself motoring around from first?
So here's Aaron Andahar, right-handed hitting third baseman for Lorain High. Otsko out at second. He represents the tying run. And the first pitch to Andahar up and in as he had to back out of the way of that one. And the count 1-0 on Andahar. He was a strikeout victim his first time up. Went down looking in the first. 6-5, Lorain right back in this thing. They've pulled to within a run. Next pitch to Andahar, stays up high in the count 2-0. Again, if you're listening in Lorain tonight, you'll have a chance to watch this one in the near future. Joe Bach is here from WLCS TV 20, Lorain City Schools Television, tying into our audio feed. Next pitch outside to Andahar, and Pascasil has fallen behind Andahar at 3-0, and there's activity in that Elyria High bullpen down the right field line. Pascasil, the pitch. Strike one as Andahar was taking all the way right there. Otsko at second. One out in the inning. Poskosil's 3-1 pitch outside, ball four. And so Andahar will head down the first. That's the third walk in the inning for Ryan Poskosil.
Andre Morales.
As he has suddenly lost command. And the ninth batter for Lorain to hit here in the second inning is Andre Morales. So Elyria batted around in the top of the second, and now Lorain has done the same here in the home half of inning number two. Runners at first and second, still only one out. Lorain has scored five in the inning to get to within one of Elyria. First pitch to Morales is popped off to the right, giving chase his Perrin, and he makes the catch in foul territory. Well, that's a big out right there for Poskosil. And there are now two down. Runners still at first and second. And hitting for the second time this inning is Thomas Holloway. Holloway doubled earlier this inning. He led off the inning with a double for Lorain High. First and second, two down now. And the first pitch to Holloway, a big cut and a miss. For strike one. Poskosil looking in. Osco at second, Andahar at first. The pitch waved at for strike two as Poskosil took something off that pitch. And the count is now 0-2 on Thomas Holloway. Holloway, the 10th Titan to bat this inning. They've scored five and still two on. Next pitch, pop down the first baseline. All good. Still in fair territory, makes the catch. And that'll do it for Lorain here in the second inning. But the Titans put themselves right back in the ball game as Lorain scores five runs here in the bottom of the second to make it a 6-5 contest. Pioneers leading 6-5 as we head to the third on the Colson and Colson Diamond Duel. It's on WEOL, and Jared, we're on the web.
At WEOL.com.
I'm a big believer in the power of we.
We got each other, and that's a lot.
We can tackle the tough challenges we face and build community through service and volunteering. It's time for you to raise your hand. Go to serve.gov and get involved in something you believe in.
How will you raise your hand when they call your name?
Are you with me?
We weren't born to fight.
Welcome back to the Pipe Yard in Lorain. Tim Elkhorn, along with on-site engineer and color commentary extraordinaire, Mr. Jared Kozar. He's doing a little bit of everything tonight. Back in the studios of WEOL, Alan Calcaterra. 6-5 ball game. Elyria High leads it as we head to the top of the third inning. And it'll be Jacob Chismadia leading off for the Pioneers here in the top of the third. Chismadia had a solo home run his first time up. 6-5 Pioneers. Calez is offering to Chismadia a pie. And the count now 2-0 on Jacob. It'll be Chismadia, K.J. Allgood, and Brendan Kazura for Elyria High here in the third. Next pitch low and away, and the count now 3-0 on Chismadia. Chismadia taking all the way, and he took a couple of steps towards first base before Sanford Washington called him back and said, nope, that one there was a strike, young man. The count now 3-0 on Jacob. Calez rocks, throws that pitch, a strike on the inside corner, and the count is now 3-2. So the count full on Elyria's leadoff hitter here in the third. Next pitch, a swing and a miss. And the throw down to first as the ball was dropped behind the plate by Drabiak, and that'll be a strikeout of Chismadia. So Calez, after falling behind 3-0 in that sequence, comes back to strike out Chismadia for the first out here in the top of the third. And for Calez, that is his third strikeout in the ballgame. That'll bring on K.J. Allgood. KJ was hit by a pitch his first time up. Galez from that full windup, and there's a curveball that drops over for a called strike. That was a beautiful breaking pitch right there by Adrian Galez.
It's the most movement we've seen on one of his pitches throughout the evening, Tim, and if he's got more like that up his sleeve, should be fun to watch.
Next pitch, a fastball that Allgood couldn't catch up to, and the count is 0-2 on KJ Allgood. Well, KJ, a big hitter for Elyria High. He's got some size in that right-handed batter's box. The 0-2 pitch from Kalez inside as he leans Allgood back. And you would think the way that Kalez has worked this sequence, next pitch might be back down low, maybe away. 1-2 pitch. It was low and inside. The count now 2-2 on KJ Allgood. Not too often you see the batter pick up the ball and just throw it back to the pitcher. 2-2 the count on Allgood. One down. Nobody on for Elyria High. Top of the third. Pioneers up 6-5. Next pitch outside. And the count is now 3-2 on KJ Allgood. Elyria led 1-0 at the end of an inning, scored 5 in the top of the second to go up 6-0. But Lorain answers with 5 in the bottom of the second. There's a swing and a miss. And Allgood goes down on strikes. 2 straight strikeouts for Kalez here in the third. 2 up, 2 down for the Pioneers. And that'll bring on Brendan Kazura.
For Lorain, this is the recipe right here, Tim, for the easy inning. You need a quick one, get yourselves back on the sticks and see what you can do.
So Kalez will try to close things out with Kazura. And Kazura waves at the first pitch for strike one. Well, it was a rocky second inning for Adrian Kalez. Chismadia had the leadoff home run. Then allowed a single to Kazura, a walk to Conley, a triple by Pierce, a double by Izzarelli. But he appears to have settled in here in the third. Next pitch is inside to Brendan Kazura. The count is now 1-1 on the Pioneer center fielder. 2 down, nobody on. Next pitch is up high in the count 3-0 on Kazura. Elyria High 5-7 on the year. Lorain putting together a very nice campaign. The Titans at 10-4. Next pitch down low to Brendan Kazura. The count is now 3-1. Kazura hitting out of that left-handed batter's box against the southpaw, Adrian Kalez. 3-1 pitch down low for ball 4. So a 2-out walk to Brendan Kazura. So with 2 down and a runner at first, that'll bring on Brad Conley. So Conley will step in. He walked his first time up, came in to score on the two-run triple by Tony Pierce. First pitch to Conley, glances off the glove of Drabiak. He'll now throw down to second, not in time, as Kazura advances on the passed ball. So Kazura now down at second base with 2 outs here in the top of the third. And the count 1-0 on Brad Conley. Next pitch, a swing and a miss. Good cut right there by Conley. Evens up the count at 1-1. Pretty consistent breeze here tonight as the wind blows in. Next pitch, another swing and a miss. Conley may have chased that one out of the strike zone. Looked to be low and away, but the count now 1-2 on the Pioneer left fielder. Tony Pierce in that on-deck circle for Elyria High. Kazura at second. The pitch up high. And the count is now 2-2 on Brad Conley. We'll join the Indians in progress tonight as they play game 2 of their day-night doubleheader in Kansas City. Tom Hamilton, Jim Rosenhaus with the call. 2-2 pitch. Bounces around and over to third goes Kazura as Drabiak couldn't find the baseball. He actually blocked it, but then once it ricocheted, Nate Drabiak had a hard time finding it for Lorain, and that gave Kazura an opportunity to hustle over to third.
a frustrating feeling to be sure if you're Draviak, but heads up base running by Kajura over there doing a great job.
So the count now full on Conley at 3-2. The pitch inside, ball four. And so after striking out the first two Pioneers here in the third, Calez has now walked two straight. He's walked Kajura and Conley. And now runners at first and third for Tony Pierce. And Pierce hurt Calez his first time up with a two-run triple. Calez working from the stretch. He'll throw, or he'll fake the throw over to first. Well, he did throw it. As he chases Conley back. Next pitch is inside. Or the first pitch to Tony Pierce inside for ball one. So Elyria looking to put something together after two outs. Runners at first and third. And now Tony Pierce will ask for time. Of course, we had Elyria softball yesterday, their ball game against North Canton Hoover. Elyria baseball tonight. I'll never hear the end of this from Tom Hamilton. There's a ball hit right back to Calez, who had slipped, throws to first in time to retire Tony Pierce. And so that'll do it for Elyria here in the third. They threaten, but strand two. And at the end of two and a half, Pioneers still hanging on to a 6-5 lead. The bottom of the third comes your way after this on the Colson and Colson Diamond Duel. It's on AM 930 WEOL, and we are on the World Wide Web
at WEOL.com.
Plant inspiration. Provide youth with the creative tools and skills to cultivate it. And you'll be amazed at what can grow. Adobe Youth Voices and the Peapod Foundation. Learn more at plantandinspire.org.
6-5 ball game. Elyria High leading Lorain as we head to the home half of the third here at the Pipe Yard in Lorain. Tim Elkhorn, Jared Kozar on site, Alan Calcaterra back in the studios of AM 930 WEOL. And for Lorain High here in the home half of the third, it'll be Nate Drabiak, Nick Billingsley, and Michael Velez against Elyria right-hander Steve Poskosil. Poskosil's first pitch is bunted back to the screen for strike one. Tribe and Royals going at it in game two of their day-night doubleheader. Indians leading that one 2-0. They're in the first inning in Kansas City. We'll join that one in progress as soon as we finish up here at the Pipe Yard. 6-5 ball game, Elyria leading Lorain. The 0-1 pitch is skied in the left field. Conley going back for Elyria, giving chase, and it is off the wall. Drabiak heading into second base will stay right there with a leadoff double here in the bottom of the third. Nate Drabiak gave that one a ride as Conley couldn't catch up to it in deep left field as it bounced off the fence. And so Drabiak on at second.
Another factor here that comes into play, Tim, the lighting. How many of these guys are used to playing underneath the lights, and how many times you might see them lose a ball up there, a ball or two that might come into play.
And now Desmond Geis is going to run for Drabiak out at second base. So Desmond Geis pinch running for Nate Drabiak as Nick Billingsley will step in for Lorain High. Well, they've got some power in their lineup. Billingsley fouls one off to the left for strike one as it ricochets off the aluminum roof here at the Pipe Yard.
We know all about the aluminum roof. We heard more about the aluminum roof this afternoon than we ever cared to remember.
A lot of aluminum here at the Pipe Yard. Boy, that aluminum can wreak havoc with a broadcast, can't it? You learn more and more every year, Jared. Next pitch low and inside to Billingsley. Count evens up on Nick at 1-1. He walked and scored back in that 5-run Lorain High second.
This time next year I might have worked my way up to useless.
Oh, you're there. Next pitch down low, and the count is now 2-1. Desmond Geis running for Drabiak out at second base represents the tying run. 6-5 ball game. Next pitch. And Billingsley takes it for a strike. Count evens up at 2-2. Our next Colson and Colson Diamond Duel Thursday on a playback for you. Firelands at Keystone. I'll make my way down to Penfield to bring you that one. There's a curveball that sliced foul off to the left and out of play. Huge splash as that ball landed in foul territory. I don't know exactly where that was, but, man, there was a big puddle wherever it landed.
just to the left of the light fixture over there in foul territory, Tim. That was pretty incredible. Now we won't know where all that water that Coach Turnus and his guys squeegeed off the field went to.
Next pitch, up high, counting out 3-2. That looked like the old lunar module when the Apollo would come back to Earth and splash down in the ocean. That water just came flying out of there. Pascasil's 3-2 pitch popped up a mile high behind home plate and out of play. I hope that wasn't Jared's windshield. Jared, did you bring the nice car over here tonight?
I brought the everyday car. I've only got one car. I don't know what you're talking about. Did I bring the nice car? And for your information, I parked adequate distance from the field today. It was one of the things I make sure I do.
The nice car that Tomo sucks a ride out of you every Friday night during the football season. That one. Is that the one you brought?
That's the one we took.
A swing and a miss by Billingsley for strike three. And so a big strikeout for Pascasil right there. One down here in the bottom of the third as Geis stays anchored at second base. That'll bring on Michael Velez. Tomo just raves about that car throughout the football season. Every Friday night when you go to his house and you pick him up and then card him wherever our game may be. First pitch to Velez. Called strike as they throw through down to second. Geis scampers back.
One of the first orders of business in any sort of broadcast, especially from an engineering standpoint, is making sure your crew's there. Yeah, I mean, the equipment can be there and it can fail, but your crew can't fail. You got to get them in there.
There's a curveball spanked down the first, scooped up there by KJ Allgood. He will beat Velez to the bag for out number two as Geis heads over to third. Nice play by KJ Allgood. So two down, Geis at third. And that'll bring on Kyle Stumphauser. Stumphauser had a single his first time up. Geis representing the tying run, two down, and there's a curveball to Stumphauser for strike one. Nice breaking pitch right there by Steve Pascasil for Elyria High. Does Tomo give you gas money for that, Jared?
No, you can usually squeeze a meal out of him, though.
Next pitch down low, and the count is 1-1.
When you're at home on your own, you live by yourself, sometimes that's one of the things you got to think about. So, if I pick Tomo up, I bet you I can squeeze a snack out of him somehow.
If you squeeze a snack out of Tomo, you're a better man than me. Here's the 1-1 pitch hit right back to Pascasil, bobbles it, scoops it, throws to first in time to retire Stumphauser and get himself out of the jam. Nice job by Pascasil after surrendering the leadoff double to Drabiak. Geis pinch running, stranded at third. Three complete here at the Pipe Yard in Lorain. Elyria High hanging on to that 6-5 lead over the Titans. Top of the fourth follows this on the Colson and Colson Diamond Duel coming your way on AM 930 WEOL. And Jared, we're on the World Wide Web
at WEOL.com.
Many uninsured Americans are receiving free eye exams that may save their sight. Eye Care America's Glaucoma Eye Care Program offers eye exams for those at risk for glaucoma. The program is for U.S. citizens or legal residents who have not had an eye exam in a year or more and are determined to be at risk. Those eligible receive a free eye exam. To learn more, call 1-800-391-EYES or visit www.eyecareamerica.org.
Elyria leading this one by a score of 6-5. Elyria led 1-0 at the end of one. Pioneers with 5 in the top of the second to go up 6-0. But Lorain answered right back, the Titans with 5 in the home half of the second. And that's where we are, 6-5, as we head to the fourth. It'll be Izzarelli, Emerson, and Perrin against Lorain left-hander Adrian Calez. Calez is offering to Izzarelli. Is outside, and the count is now 1-1 on Mike Izzarelli. Izzarelli has struck out and had an RBI double and scored in the second. The 1-1 pitch, Izzarelli, a swing and a miss. He may have tipped that one. Count now 1-2 on Mike. Joe Bach in between innings telling us that not only can people in Lorain watch this game in the near future on WLCS as the next pitch is up high, evens up the count at 2-2. But hey, you folks listening in Elyria tonight can also watch this game in the near future on YouTube. Just search Lorain Schools TV 20. Next pitch to Izzarelli is outside, and the count runs full on the right-handed hitting second baseman for Elyria. Well, that's cool. YouTube, Lorain Schools TV 20. Next pitch, foul to the screen. Count stays at 3-2 on Mike Izzarelli. See, all this work I've done for Joe Bach over the years. Joe, you never told me I could watch it on YouTube. See, that Joe Bach, he doesn't tell you things. Like he'll take you out to eat on a gift card. He never shares those things with you until it's too late. 3-2 pitch, a swing and a miss as Izzarelli goes down on strikes. Calez has fanned 5 in the ballgame.
Chris Emerson.
That'll bring on Pioneer shortstop Chris Emerson. So, Jared, I'm forewarning you. Tomo will never buy you a meal. And if Joe Bach ever offers to take you out, you're looking at a gift card. So not many options. It's whatever Joe has in the wallet that he's been holding on to since Christmas. He gets the $5 stocking stuffer, and he uses it to pay off his debts. Pitch to Emerson is up high. The count is now 2-0 on the Elyria shortstop. Oh, I kid Joe Bach. Where would we be without him? Well, maybe much fuller. Next pitch is outside to Emerson. The count now 3-0 on Chris. Emerson reached on an error in the first, later scored, struck out swinging in the second. Next pitch, it's a called strike. Count is now 3-1. Again for Lorain defensively, Nick Billingsley in left, Dee Heisel in center, Kyle Stumphauser in right. Calez's next pitch fouled to the left. Around the infield, Aaron Andahar is at third, Andre Morales at short, Ryan Osco at second, Thomas Holloway at first, Nate Drabiak behind the plate.
Tim, I had a chance last week to watch that ball game we had, Elyria and Avon Lake, with Rob Polinski, and an eerie feeling, sort of, if you're a Pioneer fan. They jumped out to a big lead there and weren't able to keep it as Avon Lake battled back. Now, the scoring not as prolific here today, but the same type of situation. Jumped out early and allowed the other team to come back.
Next pitch to Emerson inside, ball 4. And so Chris Emerson has a one-out walk. So that'll bring on Mike Perrin. It's always good when Mike D'Angelo, Mad Dog, as he's known here in the city of Lorain, walks around and shows every single solitary fan sitting here there's rain coming. It's on the radar. Look, I'm going to show it to you. Perrin takes a pitch down low for ball 1.
You know, I think we...
He's the Dick Goddard of Lorain, but he does it on an individual basis. Every single fan.
The personal touch, he likes it. I think we really need to drop the Mad Dog moniker, and I know that's going to sting for a lot of people around here. I want to call him Dog for Hire, because I got to tell you, over the past 10 years or so, that guy has donned every Lorain school's garb at some point, whether it be Clearview, Southview, Admiral King, Lorain High. He's run the gamut. Dog for Hire.
Throw over to first, diving back, Chris Emerson for Elyria High. Yes. Someday we'll find out the true answer as to who let the dog out. That's for sure. 6-5 Elyria High with a one-run lead here in the top of the fourth. Hoping to add to that advantage. Calez sends one to Perrin, who fouls it off to the left. Count evens up at 1-1. Mad Dog literally going row by row. Here it comes, folks. Here it comes. See this big green blob on my screen? That means rain.
Look what you created. He's doing this now because of you.
One ball, one strike, one out. Mike Perrin has reached on a fielder's choice and walked. Calez working from the stretch for Lorain. There goes the runner. The pitch sails by Drabiak. Down to second is Emerson. He's going to motor all the way to third. The throw offline, and Emerson ends up at third base. So on the wild pitch, Emerson is able to pick up two bases for Elyria. And he now is in scoring position with one out here in the fourth. Pioneers with a one-run lead at 6-5 Elyria. We are in the top of the fourth here at the Pipe Yard in Lorain, and now the Titan defense will pinch in as ducking out of the way is Parent. Boy, that one came up near the helmet on Mike. Count 3-1 on Perrin. Pioneer cleanup hitter Brody Stewart in the on-deck circle. Next pitch, low and inside. And on with a walk is Mike Perrin. No activity right now in that Lorain bullpen, although Brad Turnus is going to make a trip to the hill. So Turnus comes out of that Lorain High dugout to our left. Gives us time to remind you tonight's game heard online at WEOL.com. Adrian Calez's night is done. Our live stream on WEOL.com brought to you by Luxury Heating and Air Conditioning. Total indoor air quality since 1947. Thanks, Luxury, for giving us the luxury of hearing our game live online at WEOL.com. I think I heard WEOL's Jim Allen, who also is the public address announcer here at the Pipe Yard, saying that Michael Velez is now on to pitch for Lorain High. So it'll be Michael Velez taking the hill. Velez entering the ball game with a record of 2-1 on the year, has a 3.38 ERA. He is also a right-handed pitcher, as he'll get a few warm-ups to catcher Nate Drabiak. So we'll take a quick timeout. Elyria leading this one by a score of 6-5, and they have runners at first and third with one out here in the fourth. Velez on the pitch for the Titans, and we'll take this break on the Colson and Colson Diamond Duel. It's on AM 930 WEOL. And Jared, we are live on the World Wide Web
at WEOL.com.
Help friends and loved ones who live with mental illness. All we want to do is connect, to understand. NAMI can help.
Brody Stewart, Elyria's cleanup hitter, will now step in with runners at first and third. We are in the top of the fourth, one out. Elyria looking to add to a 6-5 lead. Stewart 0-2 in the ballgame, has popped out to second. And he flew out to center fielder D.D. Heisel. Actually popped out to second in the first and then flew out to Heisel in the second. And Mike Velez inherits a very tough situation. There goes the runner on the first pitch to Brody Stewart. No throw through as Perrin is now down at second base. So Perrin at second. So now runners at second and third with one out. Count 1-0 to Brody Stewart, right-hander against right-hander. Velez from the stretch, the pitch, and that's a called strike. A bit of a delayed call there from Sanford, Washington. Again, Sanford, our home plate umpire tonight. Nandy Cruz working the infield. Count 1-1 on Stewart. Infield comes in for Lorain High, looking for the play at the plate. There's a big swing and a miss by Brody Stewart. And the count is now 1-2. Indians baseball to follow right here on WEOL. We'll join it in progress Tribe in Kansas City to take on the Royals. Game two of their day-night doubleheader. 1-2 pitch. That one smoked up the middle. It'll get into center field for a base hit. Emerson scores. Rounding third is Perrin. He will score. And Brody Stewart with a two-run single for the Pioneers makes it an 8-5 Elyria advantage. Boy, that ball whistled right by Mike Velez. In fact, Nandy Cruz is checking on Velez. It may have caught him on the leg as it ricocheted off Velez in the center field. And Brody Stewart delivering Emerson and Perrin to extend the Pioneer advantage back to 3.
Yes, and the Lorain coaching and training staff out there checking to make sure everything's okay. Maybe telling them to walk it off a little bit. But in the meantime, if you're an Elyria fan, you've got to like what you see out there. Again, taking the lead and not resting on their laurels here, as we discussed earlier, having a lead, then allowing Lorain to creep back and not doing a whole lot about it. Now they jump back out there and extend it on really some aggressive base running that inning and taking advantages of some of the errors on Lorain.
Yeah, Emerson reached on a one-out walk, and then while stealing second, moved over to third on a wild pitch. Perrin then walked. He stole second to put runners at second and third. And then Brody Stewart with a big two-run single right there. And Elyria now with a three-run advantage at 8-5 as the folks for Lorain High continue to take a look at Mike Velez. And Velez on in relief of Adrian Cullez. And I think Velez is going to stay in there. And that'll bring on Jacob Chismadia for Elyria High. Chismadia had a solo home run back in the second inning. And then he struck out swinging in the third. They're going to let Velez have a few warm-up pitches.
How do you like that if you're Velez, Tim? You inherit two base runners in scoring position, take one off of what we presume to be the shin or the calf, and then you have to pitch to the heart of the Elyria order now, too. So the road gets no easier.
Not at all. And he gets to face now Chismadia, who demonstrated his power earlier in the ball game with a solo home run to left. Elyria High leading this one 8-5. As Mad Dog Mike D'Angelo now has everybody worried about the rain. He's got every fan in this place wondering if the rain is coming.
Dog for hire.
See, usually he tells everybody how much pizza he's eaten. But, man, when he saw rain on that radar, he got all excited. First pitch to Chismadia is outside for ball one. Elyria with two in here in the top of the fourth. They lead this one 8-5. Elyria with a run in the first, 5 in the second. And now 2 here in the fourth. Next pitch to Chismadia is knocked foul off to the right. Scoreboard shows 0-2. I thought Sanford called that first pitch a ball. Chismadia, a right-handed hitter against the right-hander Michael Velez. Velez working from the stretch with Brody Stewart over at first. Brody with a two-run single. That pitch is skied into right field. Stumphauser giving chase. Diving attempt. And did he come up with it? No, he did not. Down to second base goes Stewart. He will hold right there. Boy, that was a great effort by Kyle Stumphauser as he came splashing in from medium deep center field or right field to try to make that catch. Couldn't quite catch up to it as it appeared for a moment he might have had it, but it squirted out of his glove. And I think that's literally and figuratively.
Tough to see from up here. I thought he came up with the ball, too, from our vantage point. But, again, you're talking about that slip and slide out there in right field, and you just don't know what you're going to get.
So now Elyria with an opportunity to add even more here in the fourth. Runners at first and second. Still only one out. K.J. Allgood will step in. And Allgood takes one down low for ball one. Nice stop right there by Nate Drabiak, the Lorain catcher, as he was able to block that pitch from getting by him. 1-0 the count on K.J. Allgood. He's been hit by a pitch and struck out swinging. Big right-handed batter for Elyria High. KJ, the number six hitter in the Pioneer lineup. A swing and a miss right there by KJ. Evens up the count at 1-1. Tim Elkhorn, Jared Kozar with you from the Pipe Yard in Lorain. Alan Calcaterra spinning the dials back at WEOL. It's been a busy weekend for Alan. He was at the station throughout the day yesterday for our coverage from the Priebus tournament down in LaGrange. Had a great time. Congratulations to Keystone softball head coach Jim Piazza. Career win number 300. There is a fly ball in the short center field, and it drops in no man's land. Stewart will head to third. Down to second goes Chismadia, and on at first is K.J. Allgood. Boy, that was a little looper in the short center field. D.D. Heisel tried to get there, but it dropped in between him, Andre Morales, the shortstop going out, along with Ryan Osco, the second baseman. Hit them where they ain't, as the old saying goes.
Tough for the Lorain defense there, Tim. Just nobody had a shot to come up with that play in the Bermuda Triangle out there.
And so the bases are now loaded for Elyria. And now Eddie Piazza is going to come down and have a conversation with Sanford Washington. I think we're going to get a runner for Elyria. We are. It'll be Zach Rosenketter. Hope I'm pronouncing that correctly. Zach Rosenketter will be running for Allgood at first. There are some real challenging names on this Elyria roster. For guys like Gebhardt, who just has to write them down, you know, it doesn't present any problem. Radio play-by-play guy, you could butcher these names all night long. I said to Eddie before the ballgame, Eddie Piazza, I said, you don't have a Smith or a Jones or a Johnson. Oh, no. He's got these 4 or 5 syllable last names all up and down the roster for Elyria. Big huddle on the mound for Lorain High as they set their defensive strategy. Bases are full of Pioneers. Stewart at third. Chismadia down at second. And over at first, Rosenketter running for Allgood as Kazura steps in. Velez will work from the full windup. The pitch outside. They snap throw down to third. Out at third is Brody Stewart. Oh, he came too far off that bag. And what a throw by Nate Drabiak, the catcher for Lorain High. It looks as though Aaron Andujar might be a bit shaken up as he's slow to get up, the Titan third baseman. But what a throw by Drabiak. And he caught Stewart too far off that bag.
He sure did, Tim. That was a dart, and good for Drabiak, who's had a tough game at times, making some throws and having to come back and adjust to some pitches that were a bit outside. And the first error of the game, I believe, was charged to him trying to throw Israeli out at second base, I believe. And, you know, he's gotten back on the horse, and something like that can really restore a player's confidence in a game that you're not out of yet.
And that's a huge out right there, because now there are two down. Runners at first and second. Not that Lorain High is out of this totally, but boy, that's a big out. And they're still checking on Aaron Andujar. But I'll tell you what, Nate Drabiak came out of that crouch, and he fired an absolute pee down to Andujar at third. And it wasn't even close. Stewart was out by quite a bit. So now let's see if Velez can slam the door right here. Elyria has scored two. They lead it 8-5. But now there are two down as Brendan Kazura steps in. Velez back to the stretch, and Kazura slaps that one foul off to the left. Elyria looking for their sixth win of the year. Pioneers at 5-7 coming in. Lorain High at 10-4 on the year. The right-hander, Michael Velez, looking in to Nate Drabiak. Next pitch gets by Drabiak. I think they got their signals crossed, as hitting the third will be Chismadia. And now Drabiak will chase him back to third. I'm telling you what, I think Drabiak and Velez got their signals crossed right there, because as soon as that ball went sailing by Drabiak, He looked out at Velez's to say, what was that you were throwing?
Nobody was home there on that one. And I think it's fair to point out for the listeners, Tim, as well, a lot of green behind the backstop there, or where the backstop normally would be at a high school level game here at the Pipe Yard. So if a ball gets by you, you got to get on your horse to track it down in time.
So the wild pitch puts runners at second and third, so the force is now off for that Titan defense. Next pitch to Kazura is a called strike, and the count is now 2-1 on Brendan. Brendan has reached base both at bats tonight. He singled and scored in the second, walked in the third. 8-5 Elyria, two down, runners at second and third here in the fourth. Velez working from the stretch. The 2-2 offering a curveball, sliced into left field. It'll drop for a base hit. Chismadilla will score. Rounding third and scoring for Elyria High is Rawson Ketter. And it is now a 10-5 Pioneer lead. Brendan Kazura delivers a big two-run, two-out single. So Elyria High with a four-run fourth inning. And the lead is back to five for the Pioneers. And here's Brad Conley stepping in for Elyria. Two down, Kazura at first. And Conley takes a strike on the inside corner. Tribe leading the Royals 5-0. End of three. End of three out in Kansas City. Again, we'll join that game in progress as soon as we finish up here at the Pipe Yard. There's a high pop-up into short right field. Osco, the second baseman, drifts back and puts it away for the third out of the inning. But Elyria High puts four on the board here in the top of the fourth inning. And at the end of three and a half, Elyria High has pushed it back out to a five-run lead, 10-5 Pioneers, as we head to the bottom of the fourth on the Colson & Colson Diamond Duel. We're on AM 930 WEOL, and we're streaming live, Jared, on the World Wide Web.
At WEOL.com.
My injury was a gunshot wound to the left abdomen from a sniper. My first contact with the paralyzed veterans was in Walter Reed.
We help them apply for automobile grants, special adaptive housing, and vocational rehabilitation.
Now I'm going back to school to earn a degree. I'm working with a real estate agency in town, and I'm just spending time with my wife and child.
To help our paralyzed veterans, visit pva.org.
Coming your way from the Pipe Yard in Lorain, Tim Elkhorn with you. On-site engineer also offering some color commentary tonight, Jared Kozar, back in the studio of AM 930 WEOL, our very own Alan Calcaterra. 10-5, Elyria leading Lorain as we head to the home half of the fourth inning here at the Pipe Yard. D.D. Heisel will lead off for Lorain High, number 9 hitter in that Titan lineup, and he takes a called strike from Steve Poskosil. Steve Poskosil has gone the distance for Elyria. Next pitch to Heisel. That's right down the middle, and the count 0-2 on D.D. Heisel. Heisel walked and scored in the second. Next pitch, hit up the middle, chased by Emerson. Quick throw to first in time. Nice play by the Pioneer shortstop as he charged that one right in front of the bag. And Heisel is retired. One down for the Titans here in the home half of the fourth.
And a big out there, Tim, for Poskosil and the Pioneers. Heisel seems to be a guy for Lorain that we've seen that can get some things started and sort of fire up that Titan group there. And, again, you get the leadoff guy aboard and you're trailing by five. There's something you can start a fire with that. And now it's going to be tougher for the Titans to react after that out.
Back to the top of the order we go. Ryan Osco will step in for Lorain High. One down here in the fourth. And Osco takes a pitch outside for ball one. Osco has bounced out to short and had a huge three-run double for the Titans in the second. Next pitch up high in the count 2-0 on Ryan Osco. Steve Poskosil looking for his second win of the year. Poskosil 1-0 coming into tonight's ballgame. Looking into battery mate Mike Perrin. Next pitch, that's a called strike. And the count is 2-1 on Ryan Osco. Titan second baseman. Done a terrific year at the plate. Next pitch from Poskosil. Dips down low in the count 3-1 on Lorain High's leadoff hitter. Ryan Osco hitting .561 coming into tonight's ballgame. Next pitch down low, ball four. And usually when you have that high of a batting average, you also have a pretty good eye. And Osco right there draws the one-out walk. So that'll bring on Aaron Andujar. Well, Lorain High battled back earlier in the ballgame. They were trailing 6-0 at the end of an inning and a half and scored 5 in the bottom of the second to get back to within 6-5. But Elyria now with 4 in the fourth to push it back out to a 10-5 ball game. First pitch to Andujar, low and away for ball one. We are at the Pipe Yard in Lorain. This one started about 90 minutes later than we had anticipated. Was scheduled for a 6 o'clock start. Finally got rolling at about 7:35 tonight. Good-sized crowd on hand. They waited very, very patiently as the folks here in Lorain worked the field. That ball shot foul off to the right. Evens up the count at 1-1 on Aaron Andujar. He has struck out and walked in the ballgame. As Jared and I were talking earlier in the ballgame, it's Elyria and Lorain. They were going to do everything they could to get it in. They knew they had a window where radar showed that we should be able to play some baseball. And boy, did they work hard to get this field somewhat playable. Next pitch up high to Aaron Andujar. And the count is 2-1 on Lorain's third baseman. Poskosil now working from the stretch, has a look over at Osco. Comes home, the pitch up high. Osco had made a few moves off first and then stayed on the bag. Count now 3-1 on Aaron Andujar.
Interesting thing, Tim, with the crowd. You attribute some of it to cell phones, texting, calling, your social media updates. People telling you, hey, it's not that bad out here if you can make it out and save yourself some time at home in the process.
Next pitch high to Andujar. And so after getting Heisel to bounce out to start the inning, Poskosil has now walked two straight batters as Osco heads down to second. So Osco at second, Andujar at first. And here comes the heart of the Lorain order as number three hitter Andre Morales will step in. Well, Poskosil has created a jam of his own doing. First pitch to Andujar is a called strike. To Morales. Morales 0 for 2 in the ballgame, struck out swinging and fouled out to catcher Mike Perrin. Next pitch fouled behind home plate, and Poskosil is ahead of Morales at 0-2. .105 Elyria High looking for their sixth win of the year. Lorain High will try to rally again. Got back to within one earlier in the ballgame. Here's the 0-2 pitch. That one smoked in the right field. That'll be a base hit. Osco heading to third, and Brad Turnus will put the brakes on Osco right there. Andujar goes down to second, and the bases are full of Titans as Morales shoots one into right field for a base hit.
Thomas Holloway.
And here comes cleanup hitter Thomas Holloway. Well, Brad Turnus couldn't ask for any more. He's got the bases loaded with one out and his cleanup hitter up, trailing by 5. Holloway doubled in the second, popped out in the second as well. That's the inning that Lorain High sent 10 batters to the plate.
Fair to say, though, Holloway didn't miss by much in that first at-bat of the second inning, and that double went all the way to the wall, and that's when we mentioned that he had a little bit of trouble maybe getting around first, making the turn, and we saw the field conditions start to play somewhat of a role there.
Osco at third, Andujar at second, Morales at first. And here's Holloway with the bases full. Poskosil from the full windup. Man, that's a fastball right down the middle for strike one. Right-hander Steve Poskosil has gone the distance for Elyria High. Pioneers up by 5, but boy, that seems precarious right now as Holloway shoots that one foul down the right field line, and it will drop right in front of the tarp. Giving chase was first baseman K.J. Allgood along with second baseman Mike Izzarelli, but neither one could catch up to that. But for Poskosil, he's now ahead of Holloway at 0-2. If you're listening in Lorain tonight, you can watch this game on WLCS TV 20, Lorain City Schools Television. And if you're listening in Elyria, you'll be able to watch it fairly soon on YouTube if you search Lorain Schools TV 20. There's a ball hit sharply into left field. That'll be a base hit. Osco will score. Andahar comes around. He will be safe at the plate. And it is now a 10-7 ball game. Boy, the Pioneers think that they had Andahar, as the Elyria fans right here in front of us, as well as the Pioneer players, are saying he was out. And now Eddie Piazza wants to have a conversation with both his pitcher, Steve Poskosil, as well as Sanford Washington. Boy, it was close. And it was a bang-bang play at the plate. But Andahar was called safe to make it a 10-7 contest.
Tough play at the plate, Tim. From where we look, from where we're at, I thought he was safe, but it's real tough there again with these conditions and what's going on out there to make that call in the heat of the moment. But I thought he made it. It was a close play, but I thought he got in there. And again, with the collision, it just kind of leads you to believe that it was anybody's guess out there what Mr. Washington thought.
It was a terrific defensive play made by Elyria as Conley threw it into Emerson, the cutoff man, and then Emerson, the shortstop, made a terrific throw to Perrin. And it was close at the plate, but Andahar appeared to have just beaten the tag. So a two-run single by Thomas Holloway, and we've got a ball game, 10-7. As we now have a long conversation going on at the hill, as Eddie Piazza has huddled the infield. Let's see if he leaves Poskosil in there. We didn't have anybody warming up for Elyria High. I'm still trying to sort it out as to see if Poskosil is still on the hill. I think he is. Yes, he is. I think Eddie Piazza just wanted to go out there and, number one, calm his infield down. And so with one out and runners at first and second, it'll be Nate Drabiak stepping in for Lorain High. So Lorain High has made it a three-run ball game as Drabiak represents the tying run. So Poskosil still on the hill as he'll try to work himself out of this. Drabiak has lined out and doubled, and he takes a called strike from Poskosil right there. 10-7. Boy, every time Lorain High has needed to rally, Jared, they've been able to do so. But they haven't quite gotten over the hump. Trailing by three. Poskosil's next pitch down low. They throw down to second base. Tag applied and back safely was Morales.
Pretty good throw there by Perrin to get Morales headed back there, but he was able to just slide underneath there, beat the tag, but still challenging at this point in the game.
Morales at second, Holloway at first. 10-7, Elyria's lead has been sliced to three. Poskosil's next pitch, a swing and a miss by Drabiak, and the count is now 1-2 on the Titan catcher. Jared, I'm trying to look up into the lights to see if there's any drizzle. I don't think so. Next pitch, check swing, bounces away from Perrin up the first baseline. He'll now throw to second, the tag, safe at second base. As Morales scampered over to third and down to second is Geis. And so now runners at second and third for Lorain High. And the count 2-2 on Nate Drabiak. Boscasil from the stretch, the pitch, low and away, and the count runs full on Nate Drabiak. I don't see any activity down that right field line for Elyria High. We are in the home half of the fourth. 10-7, Pioneer lead. Next pitch, down low, ball four. Drabiak walks. And that's going to bring Eddie Piazza to the hill. And that will end the night for Steve Poskosil. Although he is responsible for Morales down at third. I believe that's Geis out at second, pinch running. Drabiak at first. So Steve Poskosil's night is over. 10-7, Pioneers by three. But the Titans have loaded them up with one out here in the fourth. We'll tell you about the new Elyria pitcher following this on the Colson and Colson Diamond Duel. It's on AM 930 WEOL. And Jared, we are streaming live on the World Wide Web
at WEOL.com.
Hi, I'm Bob McGrath.
And I'm Big Bird.
And we love to make music. Music can help kids learn. Did you know that making music, any music...
Like Twinkle Twinkle?
Right, like Twinkle Twinkle Little Star can help your child with language, reading, and even math.
And it's lots of fun, too.
To find out how children learn and grow with music, visit www.amc-music.org.
And you'll see...
Music works wonders.
Yeah, it sure does.
Lorain High has the tying runs on base. They've pulled to within three. It's a 10-7 ball game, and the base is still full of Titans here in the bottom of the fourth with a one out. And on in relief now for Elyria High, it'll be right-hander Zach Minnie. So Minnie on for Elyria High in relief of Steve Poskosil. Boy, Poskosil battled throughout the evening, but he is still responsible for the three runners on for Lorain. Hey, a great big hello to all of you listening online at WEOL.com. That live stream on our website presented by Luxury Heating and Air Conditioning. Total indoor air quality since 1947. Thanks, Luxury, for giving us the luxury of hearing our games live online at WEOL.com. Zach Minnie to face Nick Billingsley. And the first pitch to Billingsley is outside for ball one. Well, we mentioned people listening online as Minnie's next pitch is... Where was that one? That was a called strike. Evens up the count at 1-1. Next pitch to Billingsley. That's a called strike. And the count is now 1-2 on Nick. But a great big hello to my good friend Craig Butler. Craig listening out in Washington on WEOL.com. Way out west. Next pitch, low and inside to Billingsley. And the count is now 2-2 on the Titan left fielder. Minnie with no place to put Billingsley. The bases are loaded. The pitch, that one's golfed into right center field. Coming on is Kazura. Splashing down. He made a great catch. Tagging and scoring on the play is Andre Morales to make it a 10-8 ball game. What a catch by Kazura in right center field. And now they're going to appeal. And Morales left early. He's called out. So the run does not count. A sensational catch by Kazura. And then Morales is called out for leaving early. And that'll do it for Lorain High here in the fourth inning of play. Well, they scored two to make it a 10-7 ball game, but a spectacular catch by Kazura, and then a base running blunder by Lorain will end the inning right there. We'll be back as we head to the top of the fifth at the PipeYard in Lorain, following this on the Colson and Colson Diamond Duel. It's on AM 930 WEOL. And Jared, we are on the World Wide Web
at WEOL.com.
There's a movement afoot.
Let's move together!
Arthritis is America's most common cause of disability. Walking just 30 minutes a day can ease joint pain, improve mobility, and stop the progression of the disease. Start moving now to prevent and control arthritis. And let's move together to raise funds for a cure. Join the movement and participate in the arthritis walk in your area.
Welcome back to Lorain's Pipe Yard. Tim Elkhorn along with Jared Kozar, Alan Calcaterra back in the studios of WEOL. Boy, you won't see a more spectacular catch than we just saw from Brandon Kozura, who literally came splashing down in right center field. We talked about the standing water in the outfield tonight. And as Brandon Kozura hit the turf here at the Pipe Yard, Jared Kozar said during our commercial break, it looked like a young kid coming down a water slide. I mean, just water came everywhere. Somehow he held on to that baseball, though. And then Morales was called for tagging up too early, or leaving too early, I should say, was called out over at third. So we've got ourselves a 10-7 ball game as we head to the fifth. And it'll be Tony Pierce leading off for Elyria High here in the top of inning number five. And Pierce takes one up and in for ball one. Oh, we got a pinch hitter for Elyria High. Let's see. Pinch hitting for the Pioneers, Marquise Inman. So Marquise Inman takes the pitch up high for ball one. And now Inman takes one down low in the count 2-0 on Inman. So Marcus Inman, right-handed batter, hitting for Tony Pierce here in the top of the fifth for Elyria. 10-7 ball game. Next pitch, fouled off to the left. Count now 2-1. Jared, you knew this was going to happen. Wait 90 minutes to play this one. 7:30 start. We couldn't have a 1-0 or 2-1 game. Oh, no. 17 runs through the first four innings. I think I should have just brought a cot here tonight.
Might have helped. Might have helped.
2-1 the count on Inman. Pinch hitting for Tony Pierce here in the top of the fifth inning at the Pipe Yard. There's a curveball. Oh, a beauty as it drops in the count 2-2. That was a pretty pitch by Velez for Lorain High. Again, Michael Velez, Jr., on in relief of Adrian Cullez, who started the game for the Titans. Here's the 2-2 pitch to Inman, another curveball, and that one is hit a long way but foul off to the left.
Lost in the 90-minute delay and weather conditions that the players are putting up with, Tim. Pretty good ball game going on out there, and it's interesting to see both teams have had to kind of overcome a few obstacles, especially Elyria thought that they had a play at the plate that they would have, you know, theoretically got them out of the inning, and then Lorain with a horrifying mental error base running out there.
Inman slaps one down the right field line. Fair ball! It drops in for a base hit. Inman rounding first. He's going to dig for two. The throw, the tag. Not in time. And Inman with a pinch hit leadoff double for the Pioneers here in the top of the fifth. So Marquez Inman down at second base. And that'll bring up the Pioneer leadoff hitter, Mike Izzarelli. And now we're going to have a runner for Inman as, well, we got a full roster here for Elyria High, including a couple of add-ons from Eddie Piazza, but I don't see number two. Timmy, you got another two? Nope. Well, number two out there at second base for Elyria High as Izzarelli takes a called strike, and now they throw through back safely as the runner for Inman. So Marcus Inman gets things started for Elyria with a double here in the fifth, looking to add to their 10-7 lead. It's been an entertaining contest here at the Pipe Yard. Izzarelli shows bunt, gets the bunt down, but it's foul up the third baseline. Count 0-2 on Mike. Izzarelli hitting for the fourth time tonight. Struck out swinging in the first. Had an RBI double in the second. And then struck out swinging again in the fourth. Izzarelli comes back and picks up that bat. Runner at second with nobody out. Top of the fifth. Here at the Pipe Yard, Elyria and Lorain. There is a soft foul ball off to the right as it ricochets off the top of the first base dugout. Elyria on the first base side tonight. Lorain on that third base side. Count remains 0-2 on Mike Izzarelli. Tribe and Royals.
Indians are up 6-2 at the end of four last we heard in that ballgame.
We'll have that one in progress as soon as we finish up here. There's a curve ball that stays down low. Count now 1-2 on Izzarelli. Elyria led this one 6-0 at the end of an inning and a half. Lorain with five in the bottom of the second made it 6-5. Elyria pushed it back out to a 10-5 lead with four in the fourth before Lorain scored two to make it 10-7. Izzarelli skies one to left center field. Billingsley giving chase, and he makes the catch, a nice running catch in left center field by Nick Billingsley, as they will chase the pinch runner for Elyria all the way back to second base. Boy, what a nice running grab by Nick Billingsley out in left center field for the Titans.
And again,
what Izzarelli gave it a ride.
He sure did. We don't know what kind of swamp it is out there again, Tim, but it looks like it's been pretty rough for the outfielders to contend with all night long, and for him to track that ball down as deep as it was hit. Got to give praise to Billingsley on that one.
So here's Chris Emerson now for the Pioneers. Emerson steps in with a runner at second and one out, and Emerson takes one up high for ball one. Elyria leading this one 10-7. We're in the top of the fifth here at the Pipe Yard in Lorain. Mike Velez, right-hander on the hill for the Titans, has a look back to second base, comes home, and that ball is smoked in the right center field. That'll get down for a base hit. Rounding third will be our courtesy runner coming in to score to make it 11-7, and a hit first slide in the second base for Chris Emerson. An RBI double to extend the Elyria lead back to four. You knew as soon as that ball left the bat, it was going to get down in right center field as it dropped in between D.D. Heisel and Kyle Stumphauser. And Elyria's lead is back to four at 11-7. Two doubles in the inning for Elyria High. Marcus Inman led off the inning with a two-bagger. And now Emerson with an RBI double. Here's Mike Perrin, Elyria's catcher, as he takes one in the dirt for ball one.
Emerson back in the third inning, Tim, really gave Lorain fits on the base pass. He was very aggressive, and you can see Velez already struggling what he's going to do with him on second base right now.
Next pitch is a called strike. The count is now 1-1. One and one the count on Mike Perrin. A runner at second for Elyria. There's a curve ball that floats outside. And the count now 2-1 on Perrin. Pioneers have added a run here in the fifth. They're up 11-7 over the Titans. Velez has a look back at Emerson at second base. Emerson has already scored two runs tonight. Velez comes home, and that ball is spanked down the right field line, but foul as it hits in the bullpen on the right field line in foul territory. Count now 2-2 on Mike Perrin. Two balls, two strikes, one out. Emerson down at second. Elyria already with a run in here in the fifth. We were talking earlier about the radar, and it showed some rain moving in, although it has not yet arrived here in Lorain. There's a curveball, and it's hit by Indahar at third in the left field for a base hit. Emerson rounding third. He will score. An RBI single by Mike Perrin, and the Pioneers lead it by a score of 12-7. So Elyria High with two runs on three hits here in the inning. They seem to have timed up Mike Velez.
Hard hit ball there by Perrin, got by Andujar. And you mentioned they seem to have kind of timed up Velez, who actually has done a pretty good job of changing speeds so far. His curveball, as we mentioned, did have a little bit of swoop, lop movement on it, but he did a pretty decent job, I thought, of changing speeds up until this point.
And now Lorain High head coach Brad Turnus will make a trip to the hill. He's going to huddle the entire infield. And it looks like we're going to have a pitching change. I think Kyle Stumphauser is going to come all the way in from right field and take the mound for Lorain High. And so that'll do it for Mike Velez here tonight. Velez still responsible for Perrin at first. But Velez's night is done. Elyria has pushed it back out again to a 5-run advantage at 12-7. We'll take a quick timeout, and we'll have more from the Pipe Yard in Lorain following this on the Colson and Colson Diamond Duel. We're on AM 930 WEOL, and we are streaming live on the World Wide Web
at WEOL.com.
I always thought being a good mother meant raising my baby myself. But when I got pregnant, I realized I wasn't ready to be a parent. So I did something I thought I could never do. I chose adoption. It was really hard, but I know my baby is with a loving family and has a very bright future.
Sometimes choosing adoption is being a good mother. Visit us at ichooseadoption.org.
Dee Dee Heisel now on the pitch for Lorain High, so it'll be Heisel taking the hill as Brad Turnus utilizing his third pitcher tonight. Looking to stem the tide for Elyria High here in the fifth inning. Pioneers have scored two here in the inning. And Mike Perrin still at first as Heisel will inherit Perrin. One out. Pioneers up by five at 12-7. Again, as we sit here in the press box here at the Pipe Yard, it can be somewhat challenging to pick up those numbers out in the outfield. We thought it was Stumphauser actually coming in, but Jared Kozar telling me that perhaps Heisel had moved to right. And so that's why we saw the right fielder coming in. So it's D.D. Heisel. Boy, they're giving him a lot of warm-up pitches. And I think now he says he's ready to go. 12-7 Elyria. It's been a long night here at the Pipe Yard in Lorain. Game didn't get started until 7:30 after a 90-minute delay from what was a scheduled 6 o'clock first pitch. The first game that was scheduled for the Pipe Yard today, Vermilion and Clearview, did not get played. That game got canceled. Vermilion and Clearview were scheduled to go at it at 2 o'clock. That one got washed out, but Elyria and Lorain, after a little over 90-minute delay, is now good to go.
Well, when we set up shop here this afternoon, we knew we weren't going to get underway at 6, but neither one of us was thinking 7:30, 7:35. You know, we knew that too. But again, you know, we can't say enough about the effort that the crew out here did today. And you don't even know really what the crew consists of, if it's coaches, assistants, players were out there at times helping out. And at one point, you and I were mentioning earlier, and I think Tim Gebhardt was here, the tractor got stuck in between first and second base. You thought to yourself, I don't know about this. If the vehicle that's designed to help us out and get the field back into playing condition is stuck, kind of tells you about the evening you might be in for.
Yeah, we didn't know if it was going to be like an obstacle course out there between first and second. Just part of the ground rules when the head coach is met at home plate. Okay, you see the tractor? Guy has to leap over it between first and second. Any ball hit off that is an automatic dead ball. I mean, it was just stuck out there for about a half hour. That's when we really need a WEOL chief engineer, Glenn Smith, here. He could have fixed that thing with a Clark bar, but somehow or another, they got it rolling. It has been some type of night here in Lorain. All right, Dee Dee Heisel. I'm not sure what the holdup here is. Oh, okay. And now Nandy Cruz is waving everybody in, perhaps. They're going to wave Stumphauser in, I believe, because Geis had run for him. Or Malik Edwards, excuse me. That's what we've got. We've got a scorekeeping scenario unfolding. Malik Edwards is now coming on to play right field for Lorain High. Tim Gebhardt was trying to explain this to us. I think what happened was once we had a runner replace a player, then that player had to come out of the ballgame. So we now have Malik Edwards out in right for Lorain. In the meantime, Dee Dee Heisel has been warming up for about 8 minutes out here as he just continues to throw warm-up pitches. And in the meantime, Brody Stewart has been waiting very patiently to get his at-bat. Jared, what have we not had here tonight? Oh, my.
We haven't had the rain that Mad Dog was predicting. I'll take that right now. I will.
Yes. Tell you what. Every fan here should demand a refund after Mad Dog guaranteed rain on the Doppler radar on his phone. He showed it to each fan personally. So here's Heisel facing Stewart as we're now back to action. And the first pitch to Brody Stewart is a called strike. Elyria up 12-7, top of the fifth here at the Pipe Yard. Brody Stewart, 1-for-3, had a big two-run single back in the fourth. Next pitch from Heisel, way over Stewart's head on a wild pitch, and down to second goes Barron. He's going to try for third, and he is in safely. Well, that one got away from Dee Dee Heisel, and all the way over to third goes Barron.
And give credit to Perrin there, Tim. There was not a doubt in his mind that he was going to third base on that throw.
Well, the Pioneers now with an opportunity to add another run to their advantage. They're up 12-7. And the count on Brody Stewart is 1-1. Heisel from the full windup. Stewart knocks that one foul off to the right as it ricochets off the roof. And the count 1-2 on Brody. So Dee Dee Heisel is now the third Lorain High pitcher. Heisel 1-0 on the year. Next pitch down low. Heisel with a .91 ERA. Count 2-2 on Brody Stewart. Heisel has pitched 7 2/3 innings. He's allowed one earned run. Now he inherited Mike Perrin, who's now at third. Next pitch, fouled to the screen behind home plate. Count remains 2-2 on Pioneer designated hitter Brody Stewart. Perrin at third. One out here in the fifth. Elyria has scored two in the inning to push their lead back to 5 at 12-7. Elyria led by 6 early, 6-0, before Lorain got to 6-5. Lorain then pushed it out, or excuse me, Elyria pushed it out to 10-5. There's a little pop to the infield, and Andahar will grab it at third for out number 2. So Stewart pops out to Andahar down at third base. And that'll bring on Jacob Chismadia for Elyria High. Chismadia had a solo home run in the second, struck out in the third. Singled and scored in the fourth. And the pitch to Chismadia is a called strike on the outside corner. So Elyria has opened up a 6-run lead that was sliced to 1, a 5-run lead that was cut to 3, and now they've pushed it back out to 5 again. Dee Dee Heisel, right-hander for Lorain. Inside pitch, it gets by Drabiak, and waltzing in the score is Perrin to make it a 13-7 Elyria advantage. Boy, Heisel with his second wild pitch in the inning. So Elyria matches their biggest advantage of the night. leading 13-7 with two down here in the fifth inning of play. And Heisel will now work from the full windup to Jismadia. The pitch way up high. And the count now 2-1 on Jacob. Jared, you think we'll ever join that Indians game in progress here on WEOL? What do you think? Here's a 2-1 pitch. Spanked foul off to the right.
Tough to say, Tim, but I know at this point I can tell you that the Indians enjoy a 6-2 lead over Kansas City at the end of five innings. So we're getting closer to catching up with them, or they us, depending on how you want to look at it.
Right. We're in the fifth. They're in the fifth. That tells you the kind of night it's been at the Pipe Yard. Two balls, two strikes, two outs. The pitch, a curveball, a beauty. Ooh, did Sanford call that a ball? Wow. How's that not a strike? Ooh, count now 3-2. Oh, boy, on Chismadia. Now Chismadia will ask for time. So much for my guessing at pitches, Jared. Heisel looking in from the full windup. The pitch bounces in to Drabiak for ball four. So Chismadia with a two-out walk.
KJ Allgood.
KJ Allgood will now step in for Elyria High. KJ Allgood has been hit by a pitch, struck out swinging, and singled and scored in the fourth. Heisel from the stretch. There goes the runner. Heisel throws down to second, a bouncing throw. Tag applied, not in time. Boy, all Heisel had to do was just loft that ball down to second base, and they would have had Chismadia by a mile, but Heisel bounced it in there. And so Chismadia now down at second base.
You get the feeling, Tim, that maybe a strange turn of events here since Deedee Heisel has come on to pitch between the extended warm-ups he was getting and then the explanation about the personnel movement hasn't really helped Lorain out so far.
Not at all. Chismadia with a short lead at second. There's a called strike to KJ Allgood. 0-1 the count on the Elyria first baseman, number six hitter in that Pioneer lineup. Elyria up 13-7. We're in the top of the fifth here at the Pipe Yard. Next pitch, a big cut and a miss. And the count is 0-2 on Allgood. Deedee Heisel trying to slam the door on Elyria here in the top of the fifth and not allow any more damage. Three runs in for the Pioneers. Have pushed their lead back to six. Chismadia with a short lead at second. Heisel comes home. Strike three called as he fans Allgood. So that'll do it for Elyria here in the fifth. But they push across three more runs to extend their lead to 13-7. Coming back to the Pipe Yard in Lorain following this on the Colson and Colson Diamond Duel. We're on WEOL. We're on the World Wide Web, Jared Gozar.
At WEOL.com.
I knew I was going to college, so I always worked. My friends would come into the restaurant where I was working and want me to go out, but I had to man up and say no. You can't mess around. I heard about Freddo Student Aid at church. Filling out the free application wasn't easy, but I got it done. What would I tell other kids? Just go for it, see what happens. Don't give up on college because of money. My name is Eric. I'm going to study sports medicine. I'm going to be all right.
Elyria up by six, 13-7 Pioneers as we head to the home half of the fifth. Tim Elkhorn from the Pipe Yard in Lorain, joined by Jared Kozar back in the studios, Alan Calcaterra, of course, tying into our audio feed tonight from WLCS TV 20, Lorain City Schools Television. Joe Bach, as you folks listening in Lorain can watch this one in the very near future. Zach Minnie on in relief for Elyria High, and he's facing Malik Edwards to lead things off for Lorain here in the fifth. Next pitch is a called strike, and the count is now 0-2 on Malik Edwards. Next pitch from Minnie, just outside. Zach Minnie replaced Steve Poskosil back in the fourth inning. He'll face Malik Edwards along with Stumphauser and Heisel. There's a bouncing ball fair up the first baseline as it rolls in the right field, and Malik Edwards has himself a leadoff single here in the bottom of the fifth for the Titans.
Nice piece of hitting for Edwards there, Tim. That was a bullet right down the line. And if you're the Titans, you're looking to get the leadoff man aboard and make some noise. We talked about it earlier. You're not going to get it all back in one inning, but you can still chip away here.
So here's Desmond Geis now hitting for Lorain High here in the home half of the fifth. Geis hitting for the first time tonight against Minnie, and the first pitch from Minnie is a called strike. So Edwards with a leadoff single here in the bottom of the fifth. As once again, Lorain High will try to chip into a big Elyria lead. They've battled back from 6-5, and now they're down by 6 again at 13-7. Next pitch to Geis. Up and in. Minnie's next offering on the inside corner. That's a called strike. And the count is now 2-1 on Desmond Geis with Malik Edwards over at first. Zach Minnie working from the stretch. The pitch, a swing and a miss. And actually, it was a 1-2 count on Geis, not 2-1. So Geis goes down on strikes. And for Minnie, that'll be his first strikeout in the ballgame. Here's like Dee Heisel.
Tim, good, bad, or otherwise, Zach Minnie, a man after our own hearts, wastes no time in getting down to business on the mound. He works quickly out there. He really does.
I'm Zach Minnie's biggest fan right now. There's a pitch on the outside corner for strike one. If he's working quickly, I'm all for that. I think there ought to be a pitch clock, just like there is a shot clock in basketball. There's a bunt foul behind home plate. The count is 0-2 on Dee Heisel. It has been a long night here in Lorain. We've had 20 runs in this ball game, and we're in the bottom of the fifth. Malik Edwards on at first with one out for the Titans. 0-2 the count on Dee Heisel. The pitch stays up high. The count now 1-2 on Heisel. Heisel walked and scored in the second, bounced out in the fourth. Hard to believe he's only been up twice. It seems like everybody's been up four or five times in this ballgame. 1-2 pitch, strike three called. Oh, what a curveball by Zach Minnie. And he has struck out two here in the inning.
Ryan Osco.
And we'll go back to the top of Lorain's order and Ryan Osco. So Osco will try to keep it going with two down. And Malik Edwards at first for Lorain here in the home half of the fifth. Minnie still working from the stretch. The pitch right down the pipe. Strike one on Ryan Osco. Roscoe 1-for-2 with a walk. Had a huge three-run double back in the second. Walked and scored in the fourth. He lofts that one in the center field, but Kazura settles under it and puts it away for out number three. Well, that was a pretty quick bottom of the fifth compared to what we've had all night long. Lorain strands a runner after the leadoff single by Edwards, and that does it for the Titans as we head to the sixth. Pioneers up by six, 13-7 Elyria, five complete at the Pipe Yard on the Colson & Colson Diamond Duel. It's on AM 930 WEOL, and we are on the World Wide Web
at WEOL.com.
Okay, guys, ready? Here we go.
Let's smile and brush our teeth.
Pioneers with a 13-7 lead as we head to the top of the sixth here at the Pipe Yard. Dee Heisel Third, Lorain High pitcher completes his warm-up pitches. And for Elyria High, here in the top of the sixth inning, it'll be Brendan Kazura, Brad Conley, and Marcus Inman for Elyria. Kazura leading off. Kazura is 2-for-2 with a walk. Kazura singled and scored in the second, walked in the third, and had a big two-run single in the fourth. So D.D. Heisel will try to keep this a six-run ball game. Elyria with a 13-7 advantage. Kazura, the number seven hitter in that Elyria lineup. Heisel will work from the full windup to get things started here in the sixth as he looks into Nate Drabiak for the sign, and the pitch is low and inside for ball one. That Indians game continuing to roll along. Jared, where are they at now?
Score, the Indians lead the Royals 6-2 at the end of six innings.
So end
they
of
have
six.
Pulled ahead of us. Unfortunately, George Jones passed away, but the race is on.
Oh, you're digging deep now, buddy. You're really digging deep. Boy, if you're pulling out the George Jones lines, my goodness.
It was sad to hear about him passing away.
It was.
Friday.
It was. I mean, you talk about a legend in the world of country music. My goodness. Been around forever and ever. 2-0 the count on Brendan Kazura. Heisel from the full windup, the pitch way outside as Drabiak had to reach out and grab that one. The count now 3-0 on Brendan Kazura. Do you have a favorite George Jones song, Jared?
That was it right there.
That was it?
Yeah. The race is on.
I can't say that I had a favorite. He had a lot of good tunes. Here's Heisel's 3-0 delivery. That's a called strike. Kazura taking all the way. Count now 3-1 on the Pioneer center fielder. Boy, he had a catch tonight that he'll remember for the rest of his life. I mean, a spectacular catch and then an even better splashdown. Next pitch hit right back to Heisel. Takes a few steps over towards first and then flips it to Holloway for out number one. But that was as good as you'll see on that diving catch by Kazura earlier in the ballgame. The splashdown made it all the more effective aesthetically, but even on a perfectly dry night, that was a great catch.
You really couldn't say enough about the concentration, and it's just unfortunate we didn't have any scores to hold up that we could have awarded him for the splash. You know, that would have been all the more apropos.
Kevin Clone now hitting for Elyria High as he has his first at bat of the evening, facing D.D. Heisel with one down here in the sixth. And the first pitch is on the outside corner for strike one. So Clone hitting for Conley. Right-handed batter. As Heisel rocks and throws, Clone bounces that one, moving to his right second baseman, Osco. Fields throws in time. Nice play by Ryan Osco. Very nice play at second by the Titan second baseman. Two up, two down for Elyria here in the top of the sixth.
Tony Pierce.
And that'll bring on Tony Pierce. So Tony Pierce actually re-enters the ball game here in the sixth inning. So Pierce was pinch hit for in the fifth, but now he re-enters here in the sixth. And he lines that one in the left field. That'll be a base hit for Tony Pierce. Well, he's swinging on the very first pitch. He roped that one in the left. And that ball died in the pond out there in left field. What a two-out single for Pierce.
Tony saying, Coach, shouldn't have sat me down in the first place.
So now Mike Izzarelli with his fifth at bat of the night for Elyria High. Two down, runner at first. Elyria leading this one 13-7. This game has had a little bit of everything. Heisel now working from the stretch. He backs off the rubber to chase Tony Pierce back to first base. Heisel looking in to Nate Drabiak, his battery mate. And the first pitch to Izzarelli is a called strike. Izzarelli has had a productive night. Doubled back in the second, later scored in the inning. Heisel throws to first. Oh, they've got the runner picked off. Throw down to second, but nobody on the bag. And so sliding in is Tony Pierce. Boy, they had Pierce picked off. And yet when they threw down to second, nobody was at the bag. As coming over was Morales, late to grab the throw. My goodness. It's been a tough night defensively for the Titans. And so Pierce now in scoring position for Izzarelli. The 0-1 pitch to Izzarelli hit right back to Heisel. Throws it to first in time, and that will retire the side. Boy, quiet top of the sixth for Elyria High. They get the two-out single from Pierce, but he's stranded. And at the end of 5.5, Elyria still up by 6. 13-7 Pioneers as we head to the bottom of the sixth here at the Pipe Yard. Coming back to Lorain after this on the Colson and Colson Diamond Duel. It's on AM 930 WEOL. And Jared, we're on the World Wide Web
at WEOL.com.
Hi, I'm actor Jerry Mathers of Leave It to Beaver. Things have changed a lot since the days of black and white TV, but good values and doing the right thing never go out of style. That's why I'm working with the Partnership for Prescription Assistance to help people get the medicines they need. If you are uninsured and struggling, call our toll-free number or visit our website to see if you qualify. It's a free service, a free phone call, and in many cases, your medicines could be free too. Remember, help could be just a phone call away.
2-3-4 hitters for Lorain High here in the home half of the sixth. It'll be Aaron Andahar, Andre Morales, and Thomas Holloway against Elyria High's Zach Minnie. Pioneers with a 6-run lead at 13-7, as Minnie's first pitch is down low to Andahar for ball one. Andahar has walked twice and struck out. Number two hitter in Brad Turnus's lineup. Of course, Brad, the head coach here at Lorain High, ably assisted by his dad, Dan Turnus, who was a tremendous high school baseball coach at Southview for many, many years. In fact, Jared Kozar played for Dan Turnus, correct?
Too many.
Count. Now 3-0 to Aaron Andahar. Now, come on. Now, be nice. You enjoyed your playing time with Coach Turnus, did you not?
Absolutely.
Next pitch inside. And Zach Minnie walks Aaron Andahar. Third time tonight that Andahar has walked. Of course, Dan Turnus, I wouldn't say he was more well-known for that wrestling program, probably, but he was a heck of a baseball coach. I mean, he ran a tremendous program. First pitch to Morales is a called strike. Andahar on at first as he draws a leadoff walk here in the bottom of the sixth. Next pitch is a called strike, and the count is now 0-2 on Andre Morales. Coach Turnus ever try to convince you to wrestle, Jared?
Not even once.
I'm not stunned by that. Pitch up and in to Morales, and the count is now 1-2. I think he had some others in the fold, did he not? Throw over to first. Back safely is Aaron Andahar.
The list was short but prestigious.
Well, you're short, not prestigious. Here's the 2-2 pitch. Stays up high. And the count is 3-1 on Andre Morales. Boy, the last thing that Zach Minnie wants to do is start walking Titans. Elyria pitcher with a 6-run lead. Just throw strikes right here. And he does right there. Well, that one right down the middle. And the count runs full on Morales at 3-2. Minnie from the stretch. Here's the 3-2 pitch. Bouncing ball to second. Grabbed by Izzarelli. Flips to second for one. On the first. Double play. Oh, turned beautifully by the Pioneers. 4-6-3 on the twin killing. Izzarelli to Emerson to Allgood. And just like that, there are two down and nobody on for the Titans.
Nicely done for Elyria, but a tough pill to swallow for Lorain, because you get the feeling if something's going to happen for the Titans, it was going to be there. They had had some success with this part of the order in the past and looking to capitalize there, and it just didn't happen.
So here's Holloway stepping in with two down and nobody on. Takes a pitch outside for ball one. Boy, that was turned very well by Elyria defensively. Next pitch on the outside corner. Evens up the count at 1-1. Good strong throw by Emerson over to first to complete that twin killing as well. Thomas Holloway, cleanup hitter for the Titans. As Minnie from the full windup puts one on the outside corner, and he's ahead of Holloway at 0-2. Holloway 2-for-3, had a double in the second, and a two-run single in the fourth. Here's the 1-2 pitch, a curveball that Holloway ducked away from, and it didn't miss by much. Boy, that pitch completely fooled Holloway, and the count is now 2-2. Well, that was a real hook right there, and it didn't miss by much. 2-2 pitch, waved that for strike three. So Holloway goes down on strikes, and that'll do it for Lorain High here in the sixth inning. Six complete, Elyria by six. 13-7, Pioneers, as we head to the top of the seventh on the Colson & Colson Diamond Duel. We're on AM 930 WEOL. And Jared, we are on the World Wide Web.
At WEOL.com.
You can never know which pool safety step will save a life. Until it does. No matter how safe you feel, adding multiple safety steps can mean the difference between a close call and a call to 911. Simple steps save lives. To learn some new ones, visit poolsafely.gov.
Hope you're enjoying it tonight on AM 930 WEOL, maybe on the World Wide Web at WEOL.com. If you're listening on our website, that live stream brought to you by Luxury Heating and Air Conditioning, total indoor air quality since 1947. Thanks, Luxury, for giving us the luxury of hearing every single one of our games online at WEOL.com. 13-7. Elyria High leading this one as we head to the top of the seventh here at the Pipe Yard. It'll be Chris Emerson, Mike Perrin, and Brody Stewart for the Pioneers against D.D. Heisel. On in relief for Lorain High. Third Titan pitcher used by head coach Brad Ternus. Adrian Calez got the start. He was relieved by Michael Velez, and now Heisel, the third right-handed pitcher, or excuse me, third pitcher for Lorain tonight. As the first pitch to Emerson is up and in for ball one. Elyria and Lorain doing battle here at the Pipe Yard. Elyria has led throughout. Lorain, after falling behind 6-0, as the next pitch is down low to make it 2-0 on Emerson. Titans, after trailing 6-0, got it to 6-5. Elyria pushed it back out to 10-5. Lorain got it to 10-7. And then three more by Elyria made it a 13-7 Pioneer lead. There's another pitch down low to Emerson. And Heisel has quickly fallen behind Chris Emerson at 3-0. We are in the seventh. Crowd has thinned out a little bit. Next pitch way up and in on Emerson as he ducks out of the way. And Chris Emerson has a four-pitch walk to start the seventh for Elyria. And now for the Pioneers, we'll have pinch hitter Hunter Parsh. So Parsh is going to hit for Mike Perrin. It's ironic that Hunter will get in at bat tonight, because yesterday over at the Priebus tournament in LaGrange, when I was there for the two softball games, had a chance to bump into Elyria head football coach Kevin Fell. Told Kevin that I was working on the football schedule. It's almost finalized. I know you're excited about that, Jared. Just another year of picking up Tomo. But that being said, I was talking to Kevin Fell about Hunter Parch, and of course, he was the quarterback for Elyria last fall. Kevin very, very high on this young man. Heisel now working from the stretch. The pitch, and that's a check swing foul as it ricochets off the bat of Parch. Count 0-1 on Hunter. Not only is Kevin Fell pretty high on Hunter Parch, but in talking to Brett Larrick during the course of the basketball season, Brett thinks he's got a pretty bright future as a basketball player as well. He can shoot it from long distance. Count 0-1 on Hunter. And now Heisel steps off the rubber, fakes the throw over to first. Chris Emerson back safely. Heisel from the stretch. 0-1 pitch. There's a one-hop shot to second. Osco has it. 2 seconds for one on the first. Not in time. That ball was hit pretty hard by Hunter Parch. Fielded cleanly by Osco. And the quick flip to Morales retires Emerson.
You're right, Tim. Ball was hit on the screws, and Osco came up with it cleanly. Did a good job. Got the lead runner. And you move on to face the later stages of the lineup here. And it seems that Heisel struggled a little bit with his control since coming into the ball game, but he's put it together here and there now, and he's able to maybe depend on his stuff a little bit more, I guess you would say.
Now Ben Haywood will hit for Elyria High. So Eddie Piazza getting a couple of fresh guys in there. There's a wild pitch by Heisel as down to second will go Hunter Parch. Heisel uncorked a wild one right there as it got by Nate Drabiak. So Parch down at second with one out here in the top of the seventh. Elyria High with a 13-7 lead. Ben Haywood will step back in. Haywood, a right-handed batter against the right-hander D.D. Heisel. Heisel working from the stretch for the Titans, has a look back at Parch. The pitch way up and over the head of Haywood, and over to third will go Hunter Parch on another wild pitch. Update on that Indian score?
Bottom of the seventh inning, Tim. Cleveland leads Kansas City 8-2.
What time did they start?
8 o'clock.
8 o'clock. What time did we start?
7:35.
Where are we?
And the race is on, and here comes right up the backstretch.
We're in the top of the seventh. Oh, my. Didi Heisel really needs to find his command. Boy, he's uncorked a couple of wild ones here in the seventh. So Parch over at third, one out. Lorain infield will come in. Ben Haywood, the pinch hitter for Elyria. Next pitch, up and in, snap throw to third, and out at third is Hunter Parch. Boy, the second time tonight that Drabiak has gunned down an Elyria runner at third base. And so now there are two down with nobody on. The count is 3-0 on Ben Haywood. Heisel back to the full windup. The pitch bounces in for ball four. So two down and a runner at first. And for Elyria High, Matt McFrederick will now step in. So again, Eddie Piazza getting some fresh bodies in here with a 6-run lead in the seventh. So McFrederick will hit with two down. Ben Haywood over at first. Heisel back to the stretch. The pitch. Down low for ball one. Great big thank you to Joe Bach tonight for tying into our audio feed on WLCS TV 20, Lorain City Schools Television, And as Joe was saying, if you are listening in Elyria tonight, you'll be able to watch this one in short order on YouTube. Just search Lorain Schools TV 20. So again, it'll be up on YouTube, Lorain Schools TV 20. There's a slow topper picked up by Heisel. Throws to first in time to retire Matt Rick Frederick. And that'll do it for Elyria here in the top of the seventh. We head to the bottom of the seventh. Lorain needs to rally. They trail 13-7. Pioneers looking to close it out here at the Pipe Yard. The bottom of inning number seven follows this on the Colson and Colson Diamond Duel on AM 930 WEOL and Jared on the web
at WEOL.com.
Is this really mankind? Hi, I'm Tiffany Thiessen, asking you to please check the label before you buy meat or dairy products. Look for cage-free eggs, free-range poultry, or grass-fed meat. Better yet, buy products that are American Humane certified, animal welfare approved, or certified humane. To learn more about responsible food choices you can make, visit eathumane.org. I'm not asking you to be a different person, maybe just a better one.
We head to the bottom of the seventh here at the Pipe Yard in Lorain. Elyria High looking to close this one out. Pioneers leading Lorain by a score of 13-7. Nate Drabiak will lead things off for Lorain, facing Zach Minnie on in relief for Elyria High. Minnie from the full windup, and the first pitch to Nate Drabiak is a called strike. As soon as we finish up here at the Pipe Yard, we'll send you out to Kansas City, the Tribe and the Royals, game two of their day-night doubleheader. Minnie's next pitch, that's a called strike, and he's ahead of Nate Drabiak at 0-2. Drabiak 1-for-2 with a walk. He's done a nice job behind the dish tonight for the Titans, though, Jared. Here's Minnie's 0-2 pitch, a curveball popped into short right field. Drifting out is Arelli coming on the right fielder. And the catch is made for out number one. So Lorain High is down to their final two outs.
You mentioned Tim Drabiak's performance tonight, and you're right. He has done a nice job. Made two very impressive throws to third base to get runners out. And it's tough to ask a lot from your catcher to catch three different guys with definitely contrasting styles. He went left-hander to right-hander.
Nick Billingsley now in for Lorain High. Takes a pitch up high for ball one. Left-handed batter against the right-hander Zach Minnie. Billingsley sends one a mile high in the infield. Izzarelli moving over to the third base side, gets called off by the third baseman. And the tumbling catch is made for out number two. So Lorain High is down to their final out. I want to let you know that I'll be back with you again on Wednesday night, as that'll be our next From the Dugout show from Progressive Field. So Wednesday night, we'll reconvene here on WEOL as Malik Edwards steps in with two down and nobody on. Minnie rocks, throws. That ball's fouled off to the right and out of play for strike one. 13-7. Elyria High with a six-run lead. Titans down to their final out. Zach Minnie has done a nice job coming on in relief for Steve Poskosil. Time called for and granted to Malik Edwards. Malik singled in his first at bat in the fifth. Tribe leading Kansas City 8-2, top of the eighth. And again, as soon as we finish up here at the Pipe Yard, we're going to send it out to Tom Hamilton and Jim Rosenhaus for the conclusion of that one. A pitch from Minnie, a swing and a foul tip at the plate. And the count is 1-2. On Malik Edwards. So Zach Minnie looking to close this one out right here as the Titans are down to their final strike. Minnie looks in, rocks, throws, a swing and a miss for strike three, and that will do it. In a game that started 90 minutes later than we thought it would, it took a long time to complete it. A total of 20 runs in the ball game. The Pioneers win it by a final of 13-7. Elyria with the win, now 6-7 on the year. Lorain sees their two-game winning streak snapped, and the Titans are now 10-5 on the season. Lorain and Elyria here at the Pipe Yard. Pioneers win it by a final of 13-7.
This has been a production of Lorain City Schools, TV20 WLCS.
To purchase a high-quality copy of the program you just viewed, please call Lorain City Schools Television at 282-8400.